Audio on?
Yes.
We get sick.
Main screen turn on.
Okay, we can emulate this.
Yeah, main screen on. There we go.
Ooh. How are you, gentlemen? There is no chance to survive, make your time.
What do you say?
Old memes.
It's an older meme,
it's
but
an old
checks
meme,
out.
Sir.
There it is.
There we go.
Right, Jimmy!
There we go. Right. Welcome to what I'm going to refer to as Ghetto Dregs, because once Roll20, once you get Signal, you will all notice that there's a small problem with Roll20.
Mm-hmm.
That problem being, there's no video or voice from any of the rest of the crew. The only reason you're hearing voice is because we've all loaded Discord.
Yep.
So, yes. We're operating in backup mode right now.
Through the battle bridge.
Yep. Yeah.
Don't mind the klaxons.
This alarm will sound every minute to remind you that everything is fine.
Should it stop?
It can't stop.
No, should it stop, it is time to run.
Oh. We tried that many times, Red. It did have no effect.
Yeah. None of us can see each other.
Roll20 right now is actually, they're fiddling with their video and voice chat system. So there've been several people have had the same problem. So maybe keep that in mind for tomorrow. Be prepared to dump everybody into Discord, because Roll20 is not working as intended right now.
Yeah. Fortunately, the general stuff is updating. We also have a small problem in that our first officer is currently stuck in a turbolift train and is therefore...
Late.
So,
this is what happens when you privatise the turbo lift network.
Yes.
and the whereabouts of our counsellor are currently unknown.
Yeah, that she'll show up if she's ready.
Did anyone check under the bar?
Oh, that was the first place.
Sorry. In her office.
Yeah. So, we'll get started with the people that we have here. If Nav makes it, his character will just be inserted into a scene.
Dramatic
as
entrance.
Appropriate. Yep.
He can explain how he was late.
Yes. So now, Fox, did you get a chance to watch the previous episode?
I did indeed.
So you know what happened with Blodwyn during that episode?
Yes, I did.
Excellent.
Playing with mutated vole rats.
Yes.
Oh yeah.
Yep.
So that's good.
Maybe she might. I was considering asking if you could keep one as a sheepdog, but
I think they've been exterminated with extreme prejudice at this point.
Yeah, the fact that they eat through any cage you try and put them in makes it tricky to keep them around.
Hmm. Yes. Anyway, so let me just check what I called. Not that I honestly remember all of these things and have this whole story all plotted out nice and carefully, and I haven't forgotten what I called the colony and the planet that you're going to.
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving.
Yes. Thanksgiving on Hrenna IV.
That doesn't have nearly enough apostrophes in it.
No.
There's an apostrophe after every letter.
I realised... After apostrophe things like the Vaude villain visible. System, I was going a little overboard with the apostrophes, so...
you're also
what
showing your hand.
Thanksgiving?
Oh, yeah. the gobbledygooker. There, boom. Yeah, also you're tipping your hand with all the wrestling references.
Yeah.
Pull from a wider pool.
Well, I have for this one. Most of you probably get where Hrenna IV comes from.
Hannah-haired Herrion.
Yes. Hrenna the Hen Ahead Harridan.
Oh, yeah. See that there? Okay.
I did wonder.
That took a sec.
Yeah. So thank you to Dylan Famara for reminding me about Hrenna the Hen Ahead Harridan, who appears in The Light Fantastic.
Hmm.
So yes, you are currently in orbit of Hrenna IV, having been sent there to respond to a distress call from the colony of Thanksgiving, located on the Northern Hemisphere.
Always in the north.
Lots of planets have a north.
Hey.
Magnetic north or orbit or axis north?
We didn't ask.
Okay.
They just said north.
I mean, for all we know, you arrived in orbit upside down, coming in sideways.
Isn't that normal? The guidance controls, they'll be fixed by the end of the week, okay?
So yes, the distress call was audio only, no video.
That sounds familiar.
It basically said, this is Thanksgiving on Hrenna IV. To anybody who's listening, we need help. We're under attack. And then it cut out.
Were there loud explosions in the background?
No.
Does the call repeat?
Nope. That was it. It was captured by the Federation, and so they dispatched you immediately. As this is in Federation space, they aren't officially a Federation world, but the colonists are made up of people from Federation planets. Most of them enjoy Federation citizenship. As I said, it's in the Northern Hemisphere. You've arrived at about 7 p.m. local time.
Keep?
Yep.
Uh-oh.
Oh no!
Here's my audio.
Oh no, yeah.
Oh dear.
This could get tricky.
This is going to be awkward.
Is he still...
I don't know if he's still live.
Okay, so he stopped being live. Oh. It was maybe an internet problem on his end.
Oh no.
See, I can hear all of you fine.
Everything's fine.
Everything's fine.
I think everyone's having a day like this today.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
Yeah.
Am I back yet?
Yeah, you're back. You're back now.
Excellent.
What happened there?
I dropped a few frames, and I could hear all of you, but I wasn't broadcasting.
Okay.
See if you're back up now.
I've still got an advert for Battle Royale. Oh, no, hang on, I've got a black screen.
Oh.
Book club failed.
Yeah.
Those ads are irritating. Okay. It appears you are offline, from my point of view.
Same.
Awesome. Well, according to OBS, I'm streaming and... Oh no, my upload rate is zero.
Yeah. Oof. I would reconnect.
Yeah. Let's just stop that.
Some great uploads you got there.
Would be a shame if something were to happen to them.
Yeah.
Yes.
Like anything. Just happen.
No, I think OBS has died as well.
Oh god.
It's now stuck in the stopping stream state and won't restart it.
Yeah, that happens sometimes when you've got a weird connection to Twitch or whatever. You can just kill it from Task Manager, should be fine.
Yeah, it just kills the local recording as well though, which is a shame.
I mean...
We haven't really lost anything.
No.
We haven't really started yet, so...
No.
Just put up one of those Monty Python.
Been a series of entertaining letters of an exchange of complaints between Keeb and his internet.
Yes. Yeah. It's not dead, it's pining for the fields.
It's pining for the fields. It has ceased to be.
It's climbed up the curtain and joined the bleeding choir invisible.
The only reason it's still working is because you nailed the cable to the pole.
I will say the choir invisible is a good name for the internet.
Choir, more shouting crowd.
Yeah.
Are we back? Do we have a
signal? We are. We have signal. Right. So that was weird.
Everything's fine.
Because that was... I could hear everybody. They couldn't hear me, and I stopped uploading. So it was just my uploads that died, not the downloads.
Go Stop figure. All the uploading.
What I'm getting here is arrive in system communication.
Yeah.
Right
here.
Kem?
Yeah? Now Kem's died.
No, wait. No, that was just... That sounded like it just cut out about halfway through there.
Yeah. Right.
Should we use semaphore?
Should we play by post?
I think we might have to.
Possibly?
Okay, right.
I am.
So, there we go.
Sometimes I'm showing up and sometimes not. Interesting.
I think, are you using push to talk or are you detecting, is it, what's the word?
I am using whatever the default was and I'm not touching anything to...
Okay, yeah, if it's doing by voice activity, then it might be not sensitive enough to pick everything up.
Hmm.
Right, I shall use my theater projection.
Yes.
Yeah.
That seems to be functioning. Excellent.
Project, darling. Project.
Okay.
Loud noises.
Yes.
From the diaphragm.
So I was about to explain. You arrived in orbit about 7 PM local time for the colony. It's currently winter in the northern hemisphere of Hrenna IV, so it's dark. Your operations officer, you are seeing on your display that it snowed recently at the colony. There's a nice fresh coating of snow everywhere. And ambient air temperature is about -1°C.
Hmm.
So it's a lovely, hospitable place.
I'm not picking up. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
So there. So I gave you the distress
call. La la la.
Yep.
There we go. That's coming through.
Yeah, it's being very intermittent about what it's picking up here.
Are you using the browser version or the standalone?
Browser.
Okay.
Take 30 minutes with this going for me to actually download the
like the browser
the actual version.
Yeah, the browser version is not that is not as good basically. But if you do have you should have a settings panel somewhere, I think, and there should be an input sensitivity under voice, so you can fiddle with that maybe.
Lemons is in chat, so that's good.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
We've got Valkyrie Lemons and Soso Sundere. And Zirin.
Zirin.
Yep. Hey.
Good to see you, Zirin.
I expect a lot of the normal crowd. I know Red was here briefly. Yes, he's still here. A lot of the normal crowd will be over watching HP's 24-hour stream.
Ah, there's plenty of that
yes,
to go
around. Of course.
There's plenty of that to go around. It's fine. Yeah.
What's he currently playing?
Probably still Overwatch.
I'll go roll with Overwatch.
Okay. Yeah, there's plenty of Overwatch.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay, so that's your scenario.
Okay.
Distress call. Winter. Nighttime.
Yep. So we need to determine who sent the where they are on the planet. I guess we found that.
Yeah, you're in geostationary orbit above the colony.
Okay.
At least that's what your helmsman has told you.
More or less.
Might be upside down, but it's
fine. Yeah, the planet's upside down. We're right.
Are we detecting any signal activity from down there?
Assuming my voice is picking up, maybe this setting is the right one.
Yeah,
let's run some sensors going here.
Yep, so mental and operate for your sensors.
Alright, yeah. We can still do that in Roll20, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank God.
I hope.
Oh God, please. Oh yeah, yay, rolling.
I mean, the animated 3D dice that normally appear on screen for me aren't working, so that's good.
Take what we can get, Gabe.
Yes.
D10.
And your specialization. If I'm remembering correctly.
Yeah, you should have a D6 extra for senses.
Ah, right, that's how that works.
Yep. So there is some interference with the sensors. Something near the colony is affecting the sensor readings. You know that your normal sensor network is actually working correctly for a change.
Great.
But something local to the colony is causing some interference. You aren't seeing... Well, you're seeing exactly one life sign down there. You can't see any others.
Shield over the colony preventing transport?
Nope.
Can I get any detail on that life sign? Is it human, large, small, moving?
At this range, it's hard to gauge exactly. Your best guess is that it is human.
Is that interference something inherent to the planet, or is it something that appears to be being generated artificially?
You have a look at the logs of the initial scans from when the colony was founded, and it's not something that was present when the initial scans for locating the colony were carried out.
Well, what do you recommend, Captain?
Can we locate any life signs?
Yes, you've located exactly one life sign.
Okay. We need to send some people in to check it out. Who's volunteering?
Who's being voluntold? There aren't as many of us as usual, so...
Yeah. Unfortunately, you can't send your first officer to lead the away team. You might actually have to lead it yourself.
You don't know where he is.
That's... He will be hearing about this.
Insubordination.
I know.
I'll get the winter gear.
I'll help. Oh, wait. Oh, look.
Your counselor's just woken up.
She's woken up from her hangover. Let's get her in here so that we can hear her. Gotta go too. I can see him though, but that. We'll just get him in here.
Yeah, agreed.
Get over here.
Go to the thingy. Yeah, Discord.
Yeah, we can see him, but we cannot hear him. So that's not terribly helpful.
Yeah, no.
so that's why. Okay, cool.
Yeah, Roll 20 is majorly broken right now. So
yeah.
Welcome to the Battle Bridge.
Thank you.
So we are just assembling an awake team for investigating a distress call.
It seems the counselor wandered onto the bridge at exactly the right moment.
Yes. It is amazing how keen she was to volunteer for this away team. After all, this person is in distress and thus may need emergency counseling.
Okay, sure.
Sorry, Jack. I think at this point it's funnier for your character, given the explanation we gave for why she wasn't about. For you to not know what's going on, so
that's fine.
I'm double hearing.
I think Jack's voice was actually coming through for roll 20, but it's not consistent with who we can hear and who we can't. So
okay,
dumping everyone.
Well, if Jack is working, maybe if we all give it a refresh, it might start working.
Let's not.
Let's just keep going with this. This is fine.
I just disabled it on roll 20, so you shouldn't hear me anymore.
Okay.
Okay, so we have Jack, Vernon, and and myself. Then we can have everyone else monitor it from the ship.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Sure.
I have come back with the winter gear for you guys, probably at this stage.
Yep.
Excellent.
Oh, improvise. I can see hats.
Oh, is it working now?
It might be. Just give it, try a refresh, but we'll keep going with this unless suddenly it works, imagine.
Let's see.
You need to go to your settings, enable it. So just a quick thing, the Y team is Jack, me and Ran, right?
Yep.
Okay. Also, enabling it broke everyone for me, so
yes.
I'm going to go with nope.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. I will disable mine again.
Battle Bridge it is.
There we go.
Anyone ask, they're recarpeting the main bridge?
Yep.
Yes.
So I'm not entirely sure we actually have a battle bridge.
After not that ship, incident. No.
That would explain why the counselor had difficulty finding it.
I can see Keeb now.
Oh well, let's just go with it. Let's not worry about that.
Yeah.
Let's just go.
Right. Yeah, so let's beam down.
Yep.
Once we get changed into our winter gear.
Yep. Oh, did we get the transporter's upgrade?
Yes, so okay. You get to roll an extra d6 on any rolls involving the transporters.
Okay, but we're just beaming down, so we don't need to roll for that,
yeah.
I guess. Okay.
How many times do they screw it up in Star Trek compared to it working?
So many times.
Just the basic beam down to the planet?
No, actually, that happens all the time, and it's fine.
Exactly.
But yeah.
Yep.
When you try to reconfigure the... whatchamacallit, then.
Yeah.
Then mistakes.
Things get interesting.
We know what happens when you fiddle with the site-to-site transport subroutines, okay?
Yes.
We also know what happens when you try to do it around weird spatial anomalies, and that's why it's very hard for my character... And that's one reason why it's very hard for my character to get to just get around not being recognized everywhere.
Alright. So we're going down.
Yeah. Yep, so you materialize in... the middle of the colony. They've got like a town square set up there. Don't ask what happens materializing into the snow. It's best not to think about that.
Do we materialize on top of the snow and then immediately fall like 1 foot down, 1 foot down into it because it's piled up?
Yeah.
And that makes sense.
And yeah. It's a little darker than you expected. Half of the sort of lighting that would light up the public space doesn't appear to be functioning. Or at least it's not switched on. There's a few light sources here and there. You can sort of make out the shapes of the buildings around you. Most of them look like, here at least, colony prefabs that were here from the founding of the colony 5 years ago. And yeah, you can see a little further away down what would be the main street is a single house with a light on in the window. It's the only building that's illuminated.
Okay. So I'm going to beam in and start scanning for life forms just to pinpoint where they are. That one person is.
Yep, that one person is in the building with the light on.
Alright.
Oh, yeah,
God. Detecting life forms over there, Captain. In the house with the light on. That's where somebody probably is. That's relevant information, I think.
It is, I would assume. Okay, excellent. Let's... I go knock on the door.
Yeah.
Seems polite.
And, The snow is sort of 2-3 inches deep. The going's not too hard though. Not much wind. It's actually nice and clear at the moment. Since the snowstorm passed over, it's now a clear starry sky. You can see the moons. And it's
perfect
nice
weather for building a snowman.
Yes.
Just saying. if you want to build some sort of figurehead of snow.
It doesn't have to be a man shape.
Doesn't have to be humanoid.
Yeah.
While you're, as you knock on the door, Vern's starting to make a snow horter.
Yeah.
Which is just a lump of rock.
And you knock on, you raise your fist to knock on the door, but just as you're about to knock, the door slides open, and in front of you is a man in his sort of late 50s, early 60s, and
the human?
Yes, human. And he greets you. He's like, "Ah, you came. Excellent."
Okay, good. I'm glad. You were in distress. Where's everyone else?
Ah, yes, we'll get to that. Forgive my manners. The name's Templar, Nicholas Templar.
I see. Good to meet you.
Good. You are?
Of course. I am Captain Yenko of the USS Franklin.
Excellent. Do come in. It's frightfully cold outside.
I mean, yeah.
Okay.
I'm cold.
Yeah. Don't see any reason to hang around out here.
Yep.
Do we have any records on the colony's population?
It should be approximately 150.
150. Any specifics on who is there? Mixture
of humans, Andorians, Tellarites, and a few other species.
But we don't have like a list of specific individuals.
You have a partial list, not a full list, and obviously there's been a few births and things since it was founded.
I just want to know, like, is he on it?
Yes.
Like, a little monitoring from above. Yeah.
He's listed as the mayor.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good, I guess.
I feed this information down via earpiece or what have you.
Oh, onto transmit it to someone's data pad.
Yeah, transmit to someone's data pad.
Okay.
I'm continuing to monitor for any additional life signs or any sort of motion or anything.
Yep.
Yeah, and as you enter in, he's sort of got a smallish house, but he leads you into the front room. There's a couple of nice armchairs. He's decorated sort of the space with some bookcases with some real actual books in. He's got a small screen displaying a fireplace down where one would actually be.
Vernon will butt in when he sees that. He says, "You know, with some of the equipment you have here, some of the few little bits, you have like a hollow projector. I could make you a hollow fire. They're much better than those simple screens, if you like."
We hadn't considered that. Resources have been a little scarce, and we get by with what we have.
We'll check to see if there were any. Were there supposed to be like supply requisitions coming into this place? Are they getting supplies regularly?
Yes. They get a scheduled supply run once every 6 months. That was agreed with the Federation when they set up the colony.
Okay.
Normal Federation procedure for new colonies would be every 2 to 3 months, but because of their proximity towards the neutral zone, the Federation didn't want to have too much activity out this way, but the settlers were insistent that they had to settle this planet, and so they were kind of told, "Well, on your own head be it."
So I Vernon will ask him, what's happened to your most recent shipments? There should be some more equipment here, surely.
Yes, next one's due next month. Things go wrong, only so many spare parts, getting on just fine, and new colonists coming soon, and with the expansion we'll finally be able to get a mining setup going.
Can we have that verified? The fact that the actual shipment is supposed to arrive next month?
Yes, that is the scheduled date. So they're okay, five cool. months okay. out from their last
Send down the verification, because I'm assuming I'm just kind of doing the research.
Yeah.
As up here.
They just got
and
open
also,
comms
part of the
for
question,
you.
Remember to ask about the distress signal.
Like, yes, what is happening? I'm waiting to hear where everyone else is. The supplies don't seem that important.
Everyone else?
I assume this colony consists of more than a mayor.
Oh, yes. Yes, dreadful business. They've all gone. Seems the Yeti took them. Dreadful business.
The Yeti? Is that the Yeti?
Yes, the Yeti.
Okay.
When did this happen?
Yesterday, I believe. You got our message, surely.
The message was cut off.
Oh dear. Yes, we were under attack by a Yeti. I'm afraid I rather sort of barricaded myself in, and when it all died down, it was just me left.
Vern is searching through the database for any mention of a Yeti.
Mind if I do the knowledge roll for that?
Actually, yeah, you've heard that, so you can go for that.
Yep.
So,
okay. Go for it.
Knowledge of local wildlife, surveys, that sort of thing.
Well, like Star Trek, the Starfleet database of species, yeah. Anything, named or like resembling a Yeti, maybe.
I'm assuming science officer is relevant here.
At this point, Blodwyn would probably turn to the captain and be like, I can beam down to help them if you need me to.
Captain's down there.
Yeah. Oh. Yeah, he's here.
What
are you talking
just realizes
to?
That after she turns and
I like
he's down there.
Two. Is this?
I thought the other captain went now. The counselor.
What
captain.
Other captain?
I went down as well.
Okay.
Oh right.
Ooh, oh wait, that's not. It's actually just 14. I somehow I messed up my typing.
I mean, that's still an extraordinary success. So. You get yourself a D8.
I get myself a memory alpha.
Memory alpha link, yeah.
That's your known species that looks like a Yeti?
Ah. Or Gatto. Ape-like carnivore.
None recorded on this planet.
Huggable.
But that is the closest thing to a Yeti in the Starfleet database.
Okay, especially since this is
poisonous.
It was a it lives in a subtropical zone.
Mm. Quite fun though for a furry creature.
Yeah.
Hmm.
But yes, that's the only recorded species that would match Yeti. And yeah, the survey teams hadn't recorded much I mean, bearing in mind that this is the colony's fifth winter.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, the survey team surveyed the immediate vicinity, with the colony then left up to themselves to record further the local wildlife.
Hmm.
They were supposed to provide regular updates to the Federation database.
By survey the vicinity, you mean look under a few trees nearby and then call it good?
Pretty much. That looks like basically what they've done. There's been almost no updates since the first 6 months.
What do you want? We turned over a rock. It was good.
Yeah. There was a bug under it. We sent you a Snapchat.
When we did the life science scan, that was just for the vicinity of the town, correct?
Yes.
That's the guy we found.
Yep. So
no other life forms.
So, yeah, I'm going to extend that sensor sweep to a larger area and see if there's anything. Also, if we can do a visual sweep to see if there's tracks or anything. Realize we're a little bit far away, but hey, enhance the pixels.
Well,
highest quality.
You know from your weather report that it snowed an hour ago.
Ah.
Still.
And the,
depending on how much snow, that many people makes a large trench in the snow.
True.
Yep, it should.
Yeah. Can I try to see if he's lying?
Yeah.
I mean, he might be lying his ass off to us.
Mm. He seems very cheerful.
Yes.
Oh dear, everyone else died. Quite a shame. I mean, ha ha ha, that's fine. There's new people coming soon.
It might be his coping mechanism, in which case I would also know that.
Hmm. Well.
Yep. So
what do I roll?
For you, that is going to be... Ooh. Let's have a look.
Yeah, I know, right?
Notice, probably?
Yeah. Social and notice.
Okay. Does my notice emotional woes...
Yes, work? I will let that apply.
Cool. And since I am caring, I will also know... Oh. Does registered counselor work? No, even better. My drunk will work, because I know a thing or two about lying.
Mm. I'll let you use that.
So... to form the role. Plus 1d8 plus 2d6.
And it's going to be mental and operate for you, Kem, for the senses again.
So social, notice, emotional woes got to apply, and drunk because I know a thing or two about lying.
Ooh.
Yes!
Ooh, just,
the bare minimum!
Yep.
Yep.
You don't think he's outright lying, but he's... There's something... makes you uneasy about him, particularly about how cheery he is in the face of everything. It doesn't seem quite right somehow.
Okay.
Hmm.
Yeah, so unfortunately, Kem, you can't penetrate
the... I bang
on the
side of the screen as the sensors appear to be going on the fritz again.
Well, you can't penetrate the interference, unfortunately.
Okay. Yeah, so I'm up top cursing at my equipment and, like, banging on consoles and taking wrenches and pulling wires and such. Yeah.
But yes, Jack, so...
I just look over from where I'm playing Klingon Fighters 27 on the helm, so I was just like, you're right, then.
Captain, a quick consultation.
A quick what? Sorry?
A quick chat.
Yes, absolutely.
Time to fire
the
chat.
Yep, okay. We step away from the suspicious man.
I'll keep talking to him about the benefits of a holofire.
Yes, absolutely.
Please do, Vernon.
Yeah, he seems really interested in this and is quite happily engaging you and asking all sorts of questions. And
Vernon is
getting really into it.
Happy because somebody is actually listening to his spiel.
Someone who has never met Vernon before is listening to him. As is the custom of the... Yes.
They learn quickly.
Yeah.
So, Captain, something is definitely wrong with that guy. I don't know what it is, but something's weirding me out. He's way too cheerful to... for what has happened.
Yes. He seems disturbingly unconcerned with the fact that everyone else is gone.
Yes.
And, I mean, I realize a distress call was made. Actually, is it the same voice as we got from the distress call? Like, does
somebody
the voice
will need
match?
To make a roll for that.
Yeah, can we get the people back at the ship to actually do a voice comparison?
I could run an analysis.
Yep.
Would that be know or operate?
Operate, I believe, because you're going to run it through the computer.
Yeah. So operate scientific equipment?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. I assume you have like a record of the open comms while we've been talking to him.
Yep. and science officer for,
yep.
for running analyses.
That's probably going to be quite an easy one for you.
Hopefully. You say that.
Don't tempt fate, Keith.
You've seen my roles, right?
Oh, yeah. Oh, 10. There, see?
Bare minimum.
Just. Yay.
And a complication of some description.
Yeah,
possibly.
It's not you. That's you. There you go.
Yep. Comparing waveforms, there's yep. lots of squiggly lines on the graphics.
Well, because they distracted you from your two-player game of Klingon Fighter with Lieutenant Jones.
that man is playing Gallagher. He thinks we can't see him.
We can. But yes.
It's like adding podcasts.
They do not appear to be the same voice.
Ah.
Can I run the voice from this guy way down there against the databases we have of the any databases we have for comparison to see if we have a match? Or would that not be would we not have that kind of record?
That's not the sort of record the Federation would have.
That's what I was thinking. I realized that after I said it. Fair enough.
They would like if it was a criminal.
Reality show where they did interviews.
Yeah. Yeah, if he was on criminal charges or something, but... Yeah.
Yeah, otherwise it's just generally not a very nice thing to be... not a nice sign.
Yeah. No, they're not like... If you were the Romulans, probably yes. Yeah,
definitely.
But actually, we could... Do we have any data... Like, when they're down there with him, were they able to run the information they have on him against our criminal databases?
Yes, that would be achievable.
Would that be a no roll?
Yep.
Okay. In case there's, like, some sort of known criminal element operating here and, like, kidnapped the whole town.
That's not a good sign about their capabilities if they can do that.
It's a small town.
150 people, though.
It's... I mean, all they have to do is divert.
Since this is something really paranoid, I'm going to do this as a little nervous. Yeah. As a D4.
So you get another plot point.
Oh. Making bank.
Hey.
Yeah. The away team has snapped a couple of scans of him, so you've got a picture and some vital signs, enough to scan some criminal databases. He doesn't appear in any of the criminal databases. You can confirm, though, that this is the Nicholas Templar that is the mayor of the colony. The pictures and the bio signs all match. He was the guy who led them there 5 years ago. There is some recordings of Templar pleading with the Federation at various hearings to be allowed to settle this planet. And that does match the voice recordings.
So he's not the one who sent the... Did he say he's the one who sent the message?
No, he didn't.
No.
Okay. He knew about it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And he was... Yeah, his story doesn't quite match up.
Because something's off. We know something's off about him.
Did he say anything in this pleading to the Federation about the specific reasons as to why they had to settle this planet? And does it perhaps have anything to do with a mining colony?
He was a little vague. He claimed that the planet would be of strategic... importance to the Federation, as well as also having plenty of resources that would bring great wealth to the Federation, he felt. Despite
this is not a Federation colony.
No. And also, despite the fact that most of the geological surveys of this place said that it was not really worth colonizing for the weather conditions.
Hmm.
I mean, the Federation tends to be wary around planets.
Because currently this is weather conditions of a nice day in Canada.
Yeah.
In winter.
Yes.
Hmm. And Federation had nothing to say about this apparent strategic benefits.
It's close to the neutral zone.
Yeah, so the Federation has to act quite carefully with regard to planets close to the neutral zone.
Yes.
If they start reinforcing and colonizing lots of planets along the neutral zone, the Romulans do the same thing and tensions build. So they tend to be quite careful. They put listening posts and things near the neutral zone, and they're usually quite happy to do that, and bits of covert surveillance, but they tend to be quite cautious about exposing civilians to that as well.
Which is why I'm surprised they actually got the go-ahead.
So yes, the Federation's well aware of its strategic importance, but chose not to act on that regard. But Templar and several other sort of people who spearheaded this colony were just very passionate, and they wanted to live there. And at the end of the day, the Federation didn't really want to keep trying to stop them going there, because then they'd have to have a ship in patrol to prevent them catching civilian ships and just landing there without supplies and resources.
Which would generally be bad.
Yeah. So they did the minimum amount of effort to give them some colony prefabs and ship all the relevant people out there and give them the odd supply run.
Woo, bare minimum.
Alright. Is there any... Since I can't seem to get anything off of the planet, is there any way I can kind of sweep any relevant orbital areas, or just the area around the planet, and see if there's any signs of ships that have come through that were perhaps not scheduled, or...
Yes, if you'd like to make another sensor roll for that. Wow, I'm rolling really badly tonight.
Come on.
Oh!
Bare minimum!
Yes!
Is this what happens every time I show up?
Yeah.
All the rolls just become that clutch.
This wasn't happening until you showed up.
Sometimes I roll more ones.
My curse is spreading.
No.
The original colony ship is still in orbit. They left it there to act as kind of a communications relay. But you do detect a very faint warp signature. It seems another ship did come through here in the last day or two.
That seems like a more likely source of getting rid of all the colonists than a Yeti.
Yes.
Something about ship over serving as communication station thingy?
That would have been where the signal we got went through.
How about we look into that?
Hmm. Well, I'm guessing you guys... So, second away team onto the other ship to investigate that?
Then who's flying our ship?
I was going
you have, to... You have a backup shift for the bridge.
That's true.
Yeah, exactly.
They're actually more competent than we are.
I was going to suggest you just try to tap into it from over on our ship.
Haxmanship?
Yes.
Can I haxmanship it?
Yeah.
Well... I'm assuming I actually have the codes for this one, or I should.
I was thinking, like, that's
you should have the override codes. It was originally a Federation ship.
Oh, hey!
We have a Navarin!
Commander Jenkins has exploded out of a turbo lift somewhere.
Ah! Yeah.
Hang on a minute. Can I not? I don't know if I can hear Nav.
Science officer, as is the custom.
I'm receiving.
Ah, that's not the right link.
There we go. That's
here, look at this Yeti. We are speaking over this Yeti.
Speak to the
Come
Yeti.
Come to Discord.
Okay. Yeah. So when you're ready to give me the roll for the difficulty of trying to access the data, the communication logs.
Yep.
This is good. We can immediately send him on an away team.
I approve.
This keeps happening. Whenever we need to send an away team, someone
Okay, yep.
Wow. Equally, again, I'm not going to fill Mavin on any of the plot details. He's just going to get thrown into this.
You hacked the shit out of that.
Yes, I did much hacking.
Hacksman.
You really hacksmaned this.
What? Oh, is that the wrong link?
Or... the success was massive. It turns out they just left a default password.
Go to Keeb's Discord. That's the one with there.
Yeah, I think he's in this Discord.
No,
so.
he is in it. He's on. There we go. Hello. Roll 20 is not working.
Right, I see.
At least not in an ideal fashion.
Yeah.
Sorry about being late. Blah, blah, blah.
You should be.
You were stuck in a turbo lift.
Yep. You've been trapped in a turbo lift.
That's fine.
So yes, I'm going to do to you exactly what I did to Jack, which is I'm not going to fill you in on what's been happening. You're just going to get thrown into the plot.
All right, hit me.
So yes, Havoc. You successfully hack into the colony ship. It accepts the standard Federation override codes.
1, 2, 3, 4. That's the same code on my luggage.
Yeah, the communication log, it shows the distress signal being routed out from the colony. It lists the source as the colony's public comms terminal, so you're not sure exactly who sent that. But while you're in there, something does sort of catch your eye in some of the other logs that are available. It seems that although the ship is supposedly in a powered down state, just keep doing basic station keeping, just keeping its orbit high enough and sending out comms as necessary, it seems to have been consuming a little bit more power than that. A lot more.
Sorry, so you were saying it was doing the bare minimum?
It should have been doing the bare minimum. It's actually been doing a lot more than that.
Okay.
Can I figure out what systems were drawing the extra power?
Yes, that's listed in the logs, and you're an extraordinary success, so you get to see that. The holodecks. And the transporters.
Hello, Insurrection.
Wait a minute.
Are they currently active?
The transporters are not. The holodecks are.
Is the mayor still being occupied by Vernon?
Yes. They've been having this fantastic conversation. I'm guessing they've shifted on from holographic fireplaces now, but...
all kinds of improvements that could be made to the town. You know, rewiring all the systems and syncing them into each other so that they can do all kinds of things. And Vernon is just so excited to have somebody who actually is listening to what he has to say and has eyes haven't glazed over and walked away.
So but not once has he mentioned the Yeti to you at all. He seems completely unconcerned by the fact that 150 colonists have just gone missing.
Okay, I'm sending out updates to the to the captain and the counselor as part of the, as we discover these things. So, trying to think of how. So basically, we know that there's something funky going on with the holodecks up there, to be sure. But we need to figure out. I'm guessing that that's a separate system. I cannot see what's going on in there.
No, you can see they're up and active, but you would need to gain full computer access, which is not easy to do without waking up the ship fully.
Yep. But heading over there and taking a look ourselves would be something we could do.
Why does waking up the ship fully sound so ominous?
Because if there's something suspicious going on, they might have traps.
It might be super ominous.
Yeah. It's a top, as the saying goes.
It's a tape here.
So
if you want Vernon to come along, you're going to have to pry him away from this guy, you realize.
I honestly think that we should probably take this guy in and keep him in, like, to tell him we're trying to keep him up to keep protect him from the Yeti, but we probably want to take him in and then try and investigate this more fully. But
what are your
That's my suggestion to the captain.
What are your orders, Captain?
Keep your friends close and your enemies closer?
Yes, definitely. I think that he should. It is his civic duty to help us investigate this Yeti problem. So he definitely should be joining us on that. The question is whether he actually will join us.
Well,
we'll find out. Let's go on a Yeti hunt.
So you're gonna interrupt the two of them talking?
Yes.
Okay. He's like, oh, Vernon's like, oh, oh, well, we were, oh, Captain, we were just discussing the merits of refurnishing all the power generators with parts from the streetlight system.
Fascinating. We were just trying to work out how to deal with this Yeti problem, and we've just had a lead, so I think it's time for us all to go. You can continue your conversation on the road.
On the road? Oh, are we going on a trip?
Yes.
Excellent, excellent. Yes, this lovely engineer chap had some fantastic ideas. I don't suppose you'd be willing to loan us a few engineers to help make those changes. It seems we're a little short on personnel right now.
Really? Wow.
And he has just won the Colony Award for Understatement of the Year.
We will take that by under default. Advisement.
So okay. are we heading out, yep. Or are we heading back to the ship?
Do we need anything from the ship? I mean, well, honestly, we can get it sent to us.
You need a first officer.
That's true.
Oh.
has Jenkins reported in to us? Or is he... Because I assume that Jenkins would have remained quiet, if at all possible.
Mm. I assume so Jenkins quiet. Sort of sidled onto the bridge and hoped nobody noticed.
Yep.
Shooed somebody out of the captain's chair, dusted it off and sat down.
What? Our bridge, right?
Yeah.
Okay, yes, that's what he did then.
Is there a captain's chair on the battle bridge?
We don't look. It's just the battle. It's just somebody changed the bulb in the bridge. It's a red light. It's not a battle bridge.
I like So-So. I think it was So-So's suggestion that it's basically just the war game table in the bar.
Yeah,
more than likely.
Yeah. Modified by Vernon to have the capability.
It just rerouted all command.
Sorry, in the counselor's office.
Yeah. Yes, there we go.
Yeah, I like the idea of Jenkins being quite embarrassed that he's late for his shift.
Yeah.
And just sort of sidling in and hoping nobody notices. It's like, I've been here all along.
Yeah.
I do like the fact that simply we're in a different location, so everyone like spent half the episode looking for where everyone else was. It's like, I showed up and no one there? What? I'm not sure, where are we supposed to be?
Okay.
Right, so what are you guys doing? Are you beaming back up to the ship, or going on a Yeti hunt?
Well, I mean, we're going on a Yeti hunt, definitely. But the question is whether we'd need to go back to the ship beforehand.
Well, even if you want to beam to the colony ship, you'll need to beam back to your ship first.
Right, yes.
So that's a chance to pick up supplies and additional crewmen.
Yep, that sounds good. Let's do that. So we'll go back to the ship. We can pick up... If I can send out Jenkins, I'm not going on it, because I remember the last time that there was a firefight involving Jenkins and myself, and I have no desire to repeat that experience.
But you don't mind subjecting the rest of your crew to it?
No, actually I'm volunteering Jenkins to go on the Yeti.
Damn it!
And I will supervise from the battle bridge.
Alright, so four to beam up.
Yep.
Alright, so that's
you beam back up. Templar is a little confused. He's like, what? No, I need to be back on the planet in case the village comes back. Please.
Are you expecting them back anytime soon?
I'm sure they'll be back. It won't be a problem at all.
Well, from what we can... I'm just going to put in a... actually, can I just put in a message that... something along the lines of, okay, based on the information he's given us, there's a possibility of some environmental contamination, and he should have a medical examination.
Luckily, we're on a ship with a doctor now.
Mm-hmm.
Mm. Yes, Dr. Reddy assures you that she's ready, willing, and able from sickbay.
Of course.
Why does she always use that pun?
It's the only one she has ready.
So he's going to send him off under the pretense of he needs medical evaluation, I guess.
I think he actually might legitimately need it.
Oh, okay. Alright, we're not just trying to trick him.
No, it's... I agree.
Okay.
Because obviously he's either lying to us or something psychologically wrong with him.
Mm. Or both.
Which is... Both, probably means that he should get a once-over.
Two or three times, perhaps.
Yes.
I don't believe he's lying, but I do think that you are on point with contamination.
Okay. So
may I suggest that we send him to sickbay in the company of Victor and company?
Yes. He's protesting a little bit. Quite a lot, in fact. He's insisting that you help him find the Yeti. And demands to know why you've brought him up to the ship and doesn't want to go to sickbay. He really doesn't like being here.
Interesting.
Since he was having such a nice chat with Vernon, I'm going to send Vernon a list of helpful things he might be able to use to calm him down. These things might be wrong with you based on what's happened. So we need to just make sure that you're safe and everything's okay, and we can help your colonists later.
Vernon is still trying to talk to him about technological things, so that message will beep on his pad.
Oh well.
He may not see it.
Fair enough.
And Templar's just... he's not happy. Insists that there is nothing wrong with him. That this is all a farce. He just wants to get back to his house, back to his fireplace, and to wait for the colonists to come back.
Can I try
How
to...
How is he expecting the colonists to come back?
Does he know where they went?
The Yeti took them.
Oh, yes. Right.
Does the Yeti regularly return people on a schedule?
Can we speak to this Mr. Yeti?
He says he doesn't know exactly where the Yeti went, but he can point you in the right direction. You just need to go back down to the planet.
Can he use a map?
Give us some coordinates.
He says, No, he'll go back down to the planet and he'll point you in the right direction.
Sir, for you to be able to do your job...
Very aggressive.
No, stop. For you to be able to do your job, you have to be in the best health possible. All we want to make sure in our role as oversight is to make sure that you are still capable of filling your job. So would you please just go to the med bay, get the scans, and then once you are once you're done there, if the scans turn up fine, then you're free to go back to your home.
He just fine.
Alright.
Well, that worked. Good job.
So he's gonna go.
I just look at the captain and I go, I can't believe that actually worked.
As he's been taken away by Victor to the...
Yeah, he's just being dragged by Goblin Lynn backwards. And he's just like, fine. He gives up struggling and just gets dragged down the corridor.
It's amazing to see someone actually succeed in their job on this ship.
Yeah, I know, right?
And someone else who responds to reason.
That's honestly more surprising.
Yeah. Alright, so what are the rest of us doing then, Captain?
Well, Jenkins needs to prepare the away team for the trip to the other ship.
Hey, at once, Captain. What other ship?
Captain, does that mean that we don't have to go back down there? Because then I'd rather like to get out of these snow clothes.
Oh, yes, of course. We should keep the clothes available, but the other ship, Jenkins, have you not been keeping up with all of the events?
I was checking that the Jefferies tubes were all conforming to Starfleet regulations, sir.
Ah, yes, a very vital duty.
Considering how much time we spent in them last time, sir, it's pretty vital.
So, we have indications that another ship that is in orbit has been involved in the abduction of the civilians in this colony. We need...
Oh, well, unfortunately, terrible shame, sir.
Yes, indeed. Unfortunately... What are we moving on?
Yes.
We're moving on to the ship just as soon as you finish getting the away team ready that you are leading.
I don't understand, sir. Why would there be an away team?
So that we can investigate the ship, which has not been responding to signals. It has been responding to some signals. We've gained remote access.
But it has anomalous transporter and holodeck functionality.
Hang on. This ship is where the people were?
We think?
At one point, yes, technically
speaking. These people were on this ship. They're now not on this ship.
Or they might still be on the ship.
We don't know where anybody is. The manifest shows there was 150 people in this colony, but we only found this man who's very interested in what I had to say. I think I could really help out this colony when they do eventually come back. We don't know where.
And as such, we are deeply worried about his mental health.
Seeing as he's tried to run away.
Okay. So you want me to lead the away team to this ship to
investigate the holodecks? I will be coming with you, I guess, because I need to figure out the... I'm familiar with the systems at this stage.
Okay.
I will be coming with you because we need somebody who can actually talk to people.
Yep. So why are you coming?
Set burn to kill. Set phases to burn.
Someone page Dr. Reddy, we have a burn that needs taken care of.
Alright.
Well, Commander, if it wasn't for me, you wouldn't be having your job anymore.
That sounds pretty... Wait, sorry, what? Huh? Did I miss something?
So, who's going on this away team, then?
Let's see. Let me put my team together. I will require... Lieutenant Commander Powell. I will require... Lieutenant Commander Lloyd. And, let's see... I believe Lieutenant Jones should be available for this as well.
I'll just get
the... Is the doctor able to accompany us?
The doctor is occupied in sick bay at the moment. She's willing to send a nurse along.
That will be best, yeah. So that's three. That's most of that covered. Captain, are you going to need Commander Reginald here with you, or...?
No, you can take Commander Reginald with you.
Okay, we'll do that then. I think that's everyone.
Excellent. I tuck a knitted cap in my pocket just in case.
Just in case you have to go down directly.
So is
no, everyone... no, just in case it's cold over on the other ship.
You never know when you need a hat.
But let me just get this straight, Captain. Are you ordering me to take Lieutenant Reynolds with me?
Are you objecting to Lieutenant Reynolds going with you?
I'm not objecting, I'm just seeking information.
Why would she not be... why would she not go with you? As mentioned, we do need someone...
It depends if the mission requires a counselor or not.
Hopefully we'll be retrieving missing civilians, so a counselor would be a perfect...
Oh, sorry, sir, you were serious. I didn't realize.
I see.
I start measuring the number of steps between Jenkins and the airlock.
Out of character, Jenkins is pretty sure they're all dead. Alright, well, we better take Lieutenant Reynolds, so when we find those people, they can be ministered to.
Consoled.
We don't have any ministers.
Ministered to.
Okay. Alright. Consistent terminology. Vernon actually seems fairly eager to stay with the mayor, and because he's getting on quite well with him.
Yes. Don't want to lose your only
only friend. but it will come on the away team if ordered to. But
I'm going to need your expertise on these holodecks.
Oh, okay,
Commander Lloyd.
Reluctantly agrees, but is but still wants to go on the Yeti hunt with the with what's his name, Templar.
All right, meet me back here at 1600 hours, crew, and we will embark.
It's currently 1930 hours.
2000 hours then.
2000 hours in the evening.
Yes. In the evening, PM. Yeah. PM is very important.
2000 PM.
Yep.
Well, I never specified how long a day on this planet is.
No, you did not.
No, I'm going on the ship.
But we're on the ship.
Like 25 hours, right?
I think it's DS9 had a 26-hour day.
Oh, is it 26? Okay.
So I think it's 26. Yeah.
Okay, I'm assuming that's standard for duration. But yeah. So you know,
they wouldn't pick a nice decimal number. Oh no.
No, yeah, that's crazy talk.
And Commander Reginald, were there life signs on the ship?
I do not believe there were any at the time, but I will rescan, sir.
Yep.
Good. Do that. Just hope that our scanners don't explode this time.
They have been remarkably reliable this trip, sir.
Yeah, they have.
Bare minimum!
What is happening?
My curse has spread!
Almost every roll has just beaten the target by one.
So
technically this is by two.
Six and seven.
Ones don't count, so it's a five.
Oh, sorry, right, okay.
So, but still. Vagary
of the system.
Right.
So... there are no life signs on the ship, but your sensors can't penetrate where the holodecks are located.
Okay.
Of course!
Expected as much.
Strange.
This isn't random interference. This is... they are actively being blocked.
How many holodecks?
Two.
Two holodecks. Is that of a normal size or larger than usual?
Larger than usual. Very big.
Okay. Right.
Holodecks of unusual size.
I don't believe they exist.
So this is a colony ship, so it's got sort of big holodeck spaces that can generate for keeping people entertained on longish journeys.
Perfect.
Okay. Preparations for me include getting together the winter gear as well. Even for this.
We're just gonna get into our normal gear and
why is everyone dressed like that?
It was cold down there.
We may encounter figures made out of snow.
In fact, given you're dealing with holodecks, you kind of should be prepared for pretty much anything.
Yep. Then
I contemplate bringing a big yellow sailor's rain slicker suit, just in case.
We can always have equipment beamed across from the ship.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Then's
but in fact, once inside the holodeck, you can't.
You can teleport in and out of the holodeck.
But not if the sensors are blocked.
No, no, right. Not if, like, not right. Not if they're shielded. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, so Vern's gonna get his stuff, put away the little project he was working on before this all started, and yeah, we'll go to transporter room one, I guess.
Mm-hmm. You will meet in transporter room one, just as Dr. Reddy sends you a report.
Saying about not being able to beam with the sensors, what about our improved beaming equipment?
You could certainly try.
Oh, I'd rather not. I don't like the sound of that.
Never trust it when a GM says that.
Especially when it involves your molecules being rearranged.
I'm going to make sure to grab like 5 or 6 flashlights, one for every person.
Yeah.
Just to make sure.
But the kind of sensor tagging tech we had last session, would that enable you to like once you're inside the shielded area?
Yeah.
Okay, bring along some of those.
All right.
In case. Additionally, there was a thing. Never mind. Go ahead.
Yep. So,
Reddy.
Dr. Reddy sends a report. She gives the patient a clean bill of physical health. She says, other than him having a elevated blood pressure due to agitation, he's otherwise fine, and is insisting that you allow him to return to the planet and that you come with him to find the Yeti.
Okay, so... alright.
What's he talking about, Yeti?
We don't know ourselves.
Yep.
He said a Yeti took everyone. And he seems desperate to find it.
Before sending him back, could you tag him so that we can keep track of him?
He's not a wild animal, Jack.
I know, but...
We're not releasing him back into the wild.
He's acting erratically, and I'm worried for his safety.
First of all, he's going to notice. Second of all, I'm just going to give you this data pad marked human rights that
set up a breeding, program.
How about we send Vernon back down to the planet with the mayor, and Vernon, one of the things that Vernon can do is hook us into the computer system for the colony, so that will give us access to the colony, direct access to the colony sensors, and also allow us to keep track of where the mayor is.
Okay.
And have him slightly less stressed.
Sure, I will do that. I mean, if Captain is ordering me to do that, then I will have to do that.
This was more of a suggestion.
Oh, well, okay.
Vernon, if you do go, make sure to bring some tagging equipment, just to send whatever things might come away.
Sure. Okay.
But it seems better than keeping him here in distress.
All right. Yes. I'll keep a channel open to the away team if they need my help.
Should we perhaps ship some of Victor's team down with them?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Just one or two for Yeti protection.
Yeah, someone who won't get perhaps engrossed in either discussions of Yeti hunts, equipment, engineering, holo fires.
How about you take Ensign's Goblin Lynn?
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah. So you guys beam back down to the planet. Templar immediately invites you all back to his house for a cup of tea.
I mean, I'm going to agree to that. We'll take them. Maybe the Goblin Lynn are, you know, not
Yeti security.
But they're just scanning the area, looking around. So yeah, we'll go have a cup of tea while everyone else goes to the other ship.
Okay.
Gob and Lynn, Yeti Defense Force.
Yes, so you guys beam across to the colony ship. You materialize on one of the transporter pads there. The transporters for the colony ship are obviously big, designed to transport sort of 15, 20 people at a time. So you sort of materialize in the middle of the pad. And yeah, the ship is on emergency lighting. There's a couple of consoles nearby with main computer access. And you're a few hundred meters from the nearest holodeck.
Could I pick up go over to the consoles and start looking up transporter logs?
Yep. The transporter logs are easy access from the transporter room. They show a period of intense activity 3 or 4 days ago.
Is that about the same time as the distress signal?
No, the distress signal was a day ago.
A day ago? Okay.
Did they show activity a day ago?
Yes. They received a couple of inbound transports, but not heavy activity.
Okay.
Okay, so first thoughts, they captured most of the settlement 3 to 4 days ago, and then got most of the stragglers after.
And then someone managed to get to the console in time to send out a warning, but...
Yes.
We don't know who they is.
Oh.
Again.
Currently the best guess we have is a Yeti, to put this in perspective.
Sorry, can we confirm which direction those heavy transports were going in the previous days, and which the direction the most recent were?
So... There's a slight difference here. The heavy transporter activity was somebody activating and engaging the transporter pad on the ship. The couple of smaller transports were somebody doing exactly what you've just done, using your own ship's transporters to appear at that particular transporter pad.
Mm. Does it list to authorize these transporter usage on the ship?
Yes, it is one of the colony leaders, Tellarite. He goes by the name of, where are my notes on that? Sorry.
I'm assuming he's one of the people who we heard of in those various Federation hearings?
Yeah, he is Nick Frost Sint. Get it right.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. Let's head towards the holodecks then.
Yeah. Where I can hopefully try and get a read on what exactly is running in them.
Yeah. Jack saw that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes. So you're able to go along to that. Sorry, there was something I was going to make you roll for. I'm just trying to remember what it was now.
There.
No, piece of extra information that you could have had there. And
okay.
I've completely forgotten what the piece of extra information was going to be. I hope it's not vital for you.
It's been deleted.
I'm sure it's fine.
Well, it vanished somewhere, so...
Ah, that's right, yes. So, if you would like to do mental and notice, please.
Oh, that I can do.
I'm just waiting for this to fail and then it to be notice anyway. Ooh.
Got that.
Ooh. That's probably not happening.
Ooh.
Can I...
Is science officer relevant here?
Yes, because you're looking for a pattern in the data.
That's what I was thinking. And is this... I'm guessing the hazards thing is more specifically about physical things running at me, so this is not relevant.
Yeah, this is not something that's going to endanger you.
Yep. Okay. Okay.
Oof.
I will spend a plot... Oh, is matching success? I can't
remember. Matching is a fail.
Yeah. Okay, in that case, I'll spend one of my plot points to keep one of the other ones.
Yep.
To get an extraordinary success.
Yes.
There you go. You realize that as you're scrolling back in the transport logs, this period of transporter activity happens every year. At about the same sort of time as the first snows of winter start, there's a period of heavy transporter activity up to the ship, and then towards the middle of winter, a lot of transporter activity again, and then none till the next year.
Do they have a community calendar in their network?
Yes, yeah, you could access that. You'd need to be down in the town, though.
Oh, okay. I'll send a message down to Vernon asking him to look that up.
Okay.
Yep.
So, yeah, if we go, I guess we can cut to Vernon?
Yep, cut to Vernon.
All right. So, down there.
While the other guys wander down the corridors to the holodeck.
All right, yeah. So I'm talking to...
And I'm heading off after them because I got this record already. So.
All right, so talking to Templar and get the message on my... Well, I guess it's text message comes through on my pad. It's like, were you having any celebrations or festivals recently? Anything going on? Any fun?
Last week was the annual festival to celebrate the start of winter. We have one every year to celebrate the first snows of the year. It was a lovely affair. We all had nice warm drinks and gathered around, sang a few songs. It was great.
So just a big party then, nothing special.
Just a big, big jolly old get together, really.
I mean, that sounds lovely, but that was before everybody disappeared or was taken by the Yeti, as you said.
Yes. Strange affair. We've held this every year since we started. We thought it'd be a nice thing to do. I mean, we did name the colony Thanksgiving, and we felt it traditional that we should have some sort of festival near the start of winter, and so we thought the first snows would be a nice thing to celebrate. With the weather forecasting technology now, we know when it's going to be, a week ahead of time, and so we set up the celebration, the flakes fall, and we all go to the community hall and have a lovely evening. Yesterday, a Yeti appeared and took everybody. It's tragic, really.
Could you show me this community hall? I'd quite like to see it.
Yes,
improvements.
It's just off the town square. Let's go back up there and find it.
Okay, and take Ensign's Goblin with us for security. They're here to protect us from the Yeti. You see, that's what they're there for.
Picturing Goblin as J&J security.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Sorry.
I mean, this is admittedly, I put that in text because you were talking and I didn't want to interrupt.
Yeah. Well, it's there in text. 150 colonists went in the first wave. Unknown how many have chosen to arrive or leave since. The colony doesn't have any deep space vehicles. It has one small atmospheric shuttlecraft available that can get it up to the colony ship and back, but that's all.
So we don't actually know how big the colony is, although I assume that there will be a certain amount taken into account with the amount of supplies they get.
Well, their supply run was pre-arranged. They get the same amount of supplies each shipment every 6 months. It's not known. They haven't, because they're not an official Federation colony, they're not required to report their numbers.
You mean they don't have a census?
Well, they may do. It may be in their system logs, but they haven't reported that data back to the Federation.
Okay. So we're going to go see the town hall, see if... Just out of character, I'm thinking they might to investigate it. What's there.
So. Yeah, the town hall is it's another prefab building, and it's configured just as a large empty space, really. It would have originally been sort of like a supplies warehouse, and they've repurposed it as a town hall. It's nicely decorated, red and green decorations, bits of gold tinsel around the place. It looks very nice. They seem to have sort of mixed Thanksgiving and Christmas decorations together. It's a little strange.
Maybe there's some like Andorian holiday decorations in there as well, or something.
Yeah, and a few Tellarite ones. It seems all the colonists, all the worlds have a similar tradition around this time of year of different winter festivals, and so they've taken bits of all of them, and it's still decorated, but it's all been tidied away, and all the chairs and everything's put back, ready to work again next time. But
so as we go in there, I'm going to ask Mr. Templar to show me around on the pretense of see if I can make any improvements. But what I want to do is try and see if there are any like transporter systems or some way that they would get people off there onto the other ship. See if there's anything, any extra additions that have been made that look suspicious.
You can't see anything. I presume you're sort of doing surreptitious scans with your tricorder and things.
You know, inspecting this and like, oh, we could improve this, but you know, trying to find out.
Yeah, it doesn't. You're not picking up any transporter equipment. You do know that there's a single pad down on the planet somewhere that would have been used to make transporting between the ship a little easier, but it's only configured as a receiving pad, not a sending.
Okay.
So it just kind of makes it easier for them to lock on and beam supplies down.
Right. Right. So there's nothing there. So I'll turn to Templar. Well, this is lovely. Now about that Yeti hunt. Wanted to go on.
Yes. If we find the Yeti, maybe we can find the rest of the colony. We know which direction it came from. Would you like to see?
Yes, please. Let's go see that. Come on, team, and take the rest with us.
Yep, and as you head back out, he gestures to a mountain in the distance and says, We know it came from this direction.
How did it come from the mountain?
We're not certain. This is the way it came in from town as it arrived.
Do you have any? Should we make our way there then, or do you have any transportation that would help?
The shuttle is it's under repair. They're flyable right now.
We can fix that right up. Don't worry about that. I'm perfectly fine. Come on, show me the shuttle. I'm sure I can get it up and running.
I'm sure it'd be much quicker if we just walked. I mean, time must be of the essence.
I suppose it must be. I believe it would. Yes.
Goblin look very nervous as fixing a thing. It's like, oh no.
Vernon, you know, is jumping at the chance to repair the shuttle, but so he's very insistent that they start walking that way. Okay.
Yeah.
If you insist, you lead the way, we'll follow behind. That'll be all right, won't it? Goblin, that'll be fine. They're sort of apprehensively like, yes, following after. So now we can throw it back to everyone else.
Yep. So you guys have arrived outside the holodeck.
What was that? Oh no, it's alright. It's my heartbeat. That's fine.
It's audible to everyone.
So can I attempt to see what's running inside it?
Yes, it is running a simulation labeled workshop.
Do I have any detail? Is it able to get any details on that? The synopsis and reviews and such.
It appears to be a custom scenario written by the townsfolk, but beyond that, you don't know what it involves.
It's not got a file name of Sod the Mayor, does it?
Does it list how many users are currently in the simulation?
Yes, it does. 160.
That's as I suspected. Okay. I believe we found the townsfolk.
Excellent. Captain, mission accomplished. We're coming home.
We also need to figure out, we need to get them out of there, but I'm guessing just turning this thing...
Our mission was to find them. We've done that.
Our mission was to rescue them.
I was not informed of this.
Our mission was to retrieve the civilians.
I was given a mission to... Fine.
Please don't be... Like, you're not a djinn. You don't... The specific wording here is important. The goal is more important than the specific wording.
Have you met Jenkins?
Yes, but it hasn't stopped me from being frustrated. Okay.
Out of character? Just go inside.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, we're going inside, don't worry.
All right,
we're going
inside.
Yeah, because turning it off right away seems like a bad idea because we don't know what's going on.
We don't. I'm setting my phaser on stun and taking Jenkins out.
When you say taking Jenkins out?
Well, in.
Okay.
In.
Because you said, no, you'd set the phaser on stun and take Jenkins out. Like, wait a minute.
They're going on a date!
Yeah.
It's the holodeck!
Oh, God.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Holodeck.
Oh, shit.
I'm sure Petra can get Jenkins
right
to order the plomeek soup.
Oh, fuck off, babe.
Well, I was going to ask if you wanted to build a snowman, but, you know.
Alright, hang on. Going to invoke my, rank and send in Lieutenant Jones.
Yay.
Lieutenant Jones. Check that out.
Okay. So the door does the
Jones is like working doors. This is in there.
What a concept.
And yeah, you're greeted by a small snowy scene, and immediately in front of you is a large wooden building. Lots of lights coming from the windows. It's decorated with garlands of holly and things like that. And standing directly out the front are two Romulans.
I draw my phaser.
Yep. So, we are going to combat.
Hooray!
Two Romulans. You go first, Lieutenant Jones. What are you going to do?
Probably best to...
Surrender?
They're about 10 meters away. So it's just a short walk.
And have they got their weapons out?
Yes, they're on guard.
In that case, I will fire.
Excellent.
On stun, I would assume?
Yeah, why not?
Okay.
Tis the season and all that.
Indeed.
We'll fire it and be like, oh, I forgot to change that.
No, the wording is goodwill to all men. It doesn't include Romulans.
Exactly.
Well, I mean, they look like they should be working.
Of course Jenkins would be the one to do that.
He would?
Yeah, he would.
They look like they should be working in Santa's toy shop anyway. So.
That's racist and you know it.
Okay. It's alright, they have exclusive access to the National Elf Service, it's fine.
Oh, it's been so long I've forgotten how to do this. Right, it's forward slash R, isn't it?
Yeah. Your brackets of...
And space and...
And then it will be physical and shoot. Unless you're going to charge them and then it's fight.
And then whatever else you can talk Keeve into letting you have.
Yeah.
I think so I will. For you, that would be.
I think I'll charge them.
Oh. How much?
So physical and fight. You can then get a d6 because your fight includes your Mokbara, which I assume you brought with you.
Oh, hats, we have to get...
Oh, no, Mokbara is the style.
I never leave without it.
And your...
Yeah.
You've got your Duktag as well.
If we design some sort of, like, combat bot, then we can have the tagline for an episode fighting robot charged with battery.
Well, I will save that for later.
Yes, it's a D8, so I use.
Yep, so you'll be a D10.
Yeah, plus D10 plus D8.
D10 plus D6 plus D8.
Ooh, where's the D6 from?
Your mock bar of specialization.
Ah, yes.
Because I'm assuming, that's your fighting style, so. Yes, Scrapper would count here. You can roll that as a D4 for a plot point or a D8.
Well, let's go for D4, let's not overkill it.
Because charging people with guns and all that.
I was going to say, you don't have a lot of
D10, D10, D8, D6, D4.
Okay, I'm waiting for all ones.
There was an error with the formula.
No.
Okay, where do we...
that leads in a non-combat role. I do not want to see it in combat.
For the 8.
Make sure you pick 2.
Can you talk me through the code again?
So, slash R.
Yep.
And then open it with space. One of the curly brackets.
Space. Curly bracket.
Curly bracket. Put in all your dice. Close the curly brackets, and then K2 at the end.
And K2, space K2 or non?
No space.
No space.
KH2 also works.
There we go.
Yes.
Straight face, no space.
Boom.
Oh, okay. That's
an extraordinary success. You get yourself a D8. Damn hero dice.
We should let Lieutenant Jones do more.
Let him do some more rolling.
It sometimes works like this, and sometimes, you know, just runs straight into a wall of phaser fire.
So you charge the Romulans. Do you want to describe what happens?
One gets a fist in the face.
Yep.
Could I take out both or just the one?
Yes, as an extraordinary success, you are taking out both Romulans at the same time.
Excellent, one gets a fist to the face and the other one gets a boot to the groin.
Yep. they both slump to the ground in pain. The one that got a fist to the nose is just bleeding a little bit of green blood from the nose now.
I just shout back, clear!
Jenkins looks out, goes back, looks out again.
So we have up to 10 Romulans in there by my count. So, well, 8 now. So, best to be prepared.
How, where are you getting 10 from?
Because there are 160 people in the simulation, and there's 150-ish people in this colony.
Yes, but how-ish if you're counting births and deaths?
That's why I said up to 10.
Possibly more.
Now.
Yeah, that you're assuming all the colonists are alive.
Okay.
True.
Some number.
Lieutenant Jones. Tie them up.
Yes, sir.
Then we're going to subject them to Lieutenant Reynolds for about 10 minutes. After that, they'll tell us whatever we want to know.
Is that even legal, sir?
It's within the letter of the law, Lieutenant.
You're having the counselor counsel these people.
Not the spirit, but the letter.
The letter.
Lieutenant.
Fine.
That sounds a lot like yes, sir.
I'll go talk to them.
The Romulan with the injured groin just spits in your face.
Ooh.
Isn't that the kind of common in their culture?
Don't kick shame the Romulans.
If anybody knows Legbot's quote code, please add that to the quotes database.
Don't kink shame the Romulans is an amazing quote.
It could also work for being added to the advice as well, but...
I don't know, would I slap him now? Kind of think I would.
The Romulan?
Yeah, the Romulan, not Jenkins.
I mean, that is against the letter of the law.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I wouldn't.
Okay.
So I'll try to talk to the other one. I'll just ignore the guy who just spat at me.
Yep. That one is He's sort of trying to stem the bleeding from his nose.
I grab my small med kit and try to help him.
Yep.
Try to patch him up as best possible. And while I do that, I ask him what is going on.
I think at this point I'd be looking through the window into the room,
or like looking through the doors. Or in the hall.
We're kind of in the field with the workshop off in the distance, right?
I thought they were in front of the doors of the workshop.
It's nearby. Oh. While we wait for the extra info, just quick cut to Vernon and everyone like trudging through the forest.
Yep.
Getting wet, getting covered in snow.
Yeah, really miserable. But Templar's still keeping his spirits up and still talking about stuff.
We're having, you know, very lively discussions about technology, and while Ensign Gobb and Lynn are looking at us like very confused while trying to keep us safe.
Improvisational technology, to be specific.
Exactly. And then we got back up to the holodeck.
Yep. And so the Romulan appreciates your efforts, and he's just like, we were just told to guard them. Really?
The civilians from the colony?
Yes, told to keep them in here.
Why do you have them here?
They were already here.
Okay. But why do you need to guard them then?
Stop them leaving. They're working for us now.
Working for you? What are they doing in there?
Making stuff. It's a bit of a thick Romulan, this one, but...
Yeah, I was going to say.
This is the guy you stick on guard duty and hope he doesn't ask questions. Well, no, he won't ask questions.
It's like those two guards in Monty Python.
No, I was thinking the guard from Hitchhikers.
Yes. That's basically what I was going for with this guy.
Yeah. So at this point, I give up. Because
who
even I can't get through that.
To guard?
What?
Who told them to guard?
I don't care. I can't ask him more.
He says, the boss.
And who's your boss?
You don't know the boss? Oh dear.
Obviously, otherwise I wouldn't be asking who he is.
Yeah, we just call him the boss. Don't know his actual name.
What does he look like, your boss?
Tall, dark hair, bowl cut, pointy ears.
Distinctive.
Yes.
Okay, should we just keep going and leave these people?
So this whole fight took place in like the field just by the entrance to the holodeck.
Yes.
Right?
So yeah, you've got a short space between to this building.
Okay. And the building is okay. By the way, I checked to see before we head deeper in, what is the status of the safety interlocks on the holodeck?
Safety's disabled. That's why you were able to injure these guys.
Yep, as I suspected.
Does safety stop you from punching someone in the face?
Yeah.
Yep.
Because it's all force fields, so they'll just put a force field in front of your fist to slow it down. It stops you getting injured.
Right.
Yeah, I guess they prevent you from punching fast enough to actually...
Ah, okay.
Alright. And it'll disable phases and stuff
right,
if you walk in if they're enabled.
Okay.
Can we turn the safety off? Or on? The other thing. Can we turn the safety on?
Did you do that?
Could I?
Yeah.
That would make sure that none of the civilians got hurt. That seems like a priority.
Mm-hmm. Because technically then we could just ignore whatever other stuff that might be here and just focus on the civilians.
And we just went from combat to a Benny Hill chase.
Pretty much.
Okay. I am changing. Okay, I am reducing. I am turning it on and reducing the rating of this episode to a lower age range.
Yep, that will be a dice roll of mental and operate, because that's computers.
Computer.
Yep, my hacksmanship is much in use today.
Yep. We are now a universal.
Computer. So
a little nervous. Can I use a little nervous here, just because, like, okay, everything will be safe now.
Mm. Just parental controlled the whole.
Oh no, that's not happening.
Ooh.
You've made it more lethal.
Yeah.
The arts just disappeared.
Safety.
Can you set holodecks to kill?
We set safety up, right?
Yes.
Intruders from
that.
The fifth dimension.
That's very nearly a botch.
Very nearly.
Yeah.
112. Oh.
I really don't. I know what was going to happen on a botch, but I don't know.
Right, anyway.
No, you're not going to be trapped in the holodeck. That would have been the botch.
Yes.
Yes.
It
I was expecting that.
The door shut.
Yeah, it was nearly the Fisher special. But it was only on 3 dice, so not quite like the real McCoy.
The real Fisher special is 5 dice and all ones, or at least close to that.
So the holodeck detects your hack attempt. Turns out that, well, I say hack, you were trying to change the safeties. It seems that somebody had adjusted the holodeck programming to trigger a red alert when somebody tried to change the safeties. Nothing happens on the holodeck settings, but the red alert sirens are going off. Not only out in the corridor on the ship, which is now slowly waking up, but also, weirdly, there appears to be some red alert klaxons inside the workshop, and now they're going off as well.
They do not want it to be safe at all! This is the opposite of what you want an alarm to do! Gah!
Could you turn the noise down?
I'm guessing at this stage I'm probably locked out.
Yep, you're locked out of the holodeck arch now.
Yep. No, I'm locked out of this.
I reach into my med bag, find some gauze, and put it into my ears.
Let's get into start before running for the workshop.
Yeah.
Yep.
So, you were already by the doors to the workshop, because that's where the guards were.
So, I'm following Lieutenant Jones in such a fashion that they are always a couple of steps in front of me, but I look like I'm
good
leaving.
Move.
Okay, is the door locked, or...?
Nope.
Okay,
you can just open the door for the workshop.
I push the door open.
And inside you find 4 Romulans running towards you.
Can we have the door slam back and hit Commander Jenkins?
I think at this point I would probably shut the door again, and the other guys, we're going to need more than one guy with a fate. Romulans, basically.
So you sort of open the door, see the Romulans, and go, nope! Close the door again.
Pretty much.
They have a cave troll.
Can I order them to stand down?
The Romulans.
No one's stopping you. No one's stopping you at all from doing that. Step out into the middle of the corridor and do that.
Yeah, into the long fire.
No. I'm gonna tell them that since we have superior firepower, if they do not stand down, they will be...
I will just point out, you are telling this to a door.
Yeah, you...
They can hear me on the other side of the door.
Horrifying.
Okay, I would like you to roll.
Yes.
Social and influence, please.
Okay, and since I am a trained diplomat, registered counselor would probably help. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah, that's a reasonably high roll, high difficulty.
Hmm. That's pretty high.
Yeah. Hey, one of them's a bit thick, which is why it's only a D8.
Hey, Havoc. How about you spend a plot point and give them a complication?
I actually could do that.
Mm.
Actually, I'm going to do that. It's a deeply confused.
Yep.
Or, I have to point out, you could step back one of your complications.
Yes.
But, you know.
Or, actually, I could just step down the red alert.
Yep. Yeah, your board should have gone away, actually, because you changed scenes. You're actually doing stuff now.
Yeah.
I'm guessing that my psychology specialization on influence is definitely a help.
Yep.
So, okay.
Basically, down to a D6.
Basically, that now that someone's talking and we're like, hey, wait, what's going on? And so they're less alert.
Yep.
And also less red somehow.
D12, 1D8.
More green.
D6.
They've silenced some of the alarms inside the holodeck.
I assume they got a look at you.
Yeah.
So they're like, okay, we know what's up. Turn the alert off.
Cross my fingers.
It's just Federation.
Damn it, even with my one plot point, I can't get there.
Oh well.
Can I? No.
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 No, you can only,
I'll just tie it.
You can only make it even, yeah.
I rolled a 1 on my D12.
Oh no.
That seems about par for the course.
It's one of the 12 sides.
Yes.
So yeah, you were trying to tell them this, but because you were yelling because you couldn't hear because of the gauze in your ears, and just being generally deafened by the alarms, it sounded really super aggressive instead. And so instead of backing down, they kicked the door open. Was anybody standing in front of the door?
That would have been me.
Excellent.
I would have been.
You get a door to the face.
What?
But I think Jenkins has enough now to be standing like... Okay, can Jenkins be behind the door that's just been kicked open now?
Yeah.
Yes, okay, excellent.
That also sounds like Jenkins, yeah.
So,
yep.
Blodwyn, you've been hit by a door.
How adorable.
You've been hit by...
Now...
A door.
A moved string.
Like, Jones did open the door, so like it was probably only partially closed, so it was kind of really more ajar.
Yeah, you didn't get hit by a jar. Anyway, so Bloodwyn, you don't get to go first, but you get to pick who goes first, Romulans or anybody else in this scenario.
Yeah, but who? I think we should
Hey, those
go
the choices
with.
Game.
I think we will go to Alex Powell.
Okay. So I'm trying to think of where I am right now. I think would I be so? The arch is relatively close to this building, correct?
Yeah, you moved up to the building, and so instead of running back out, you just did computer arch. And we're then trying to program it, which I presume the arch is still up.
Yeah. So they just kicked it open. I am not useful in a fight, but I am potentially useful in trying to override this lockout and mess with the environment.
Yep.
So I'm going to go for that. Yep. So just trying to override the lockout to not necessarily engage the safeties, but you know, try to manipulate this area to our advantage in some way if I succeed. Possibly by dropping a... I've got something thematically appropriate. I'll think about it when I actually succeed. If I do.
Drop a strawberry.
When I succeed.
If I don't succeed, I get to talk about how it went wrong.
Mm. Yeah. Positive. I mean, like, Christmas trees would work.
Sack of coal.
Slayers. Yeah, coal. Yeah.
Santa's sleigh filled with presents.
Yep.
I'm glad most of you have cottoned on to what's going on here now.
Okay, so this is why I
thought
he
got there with
my character realized this a while earlier. That's why he's wearing his clothing.
Yeah. I knew Nicholas Templar would be a little bit too obscure for most of you to figure out. But Nick Frost, I thought you would get, so.
Yeah.
I can use my tripod, right?
Rang a bell. I just can't remember what from.
Simon Templar, otherwise known as the Saint.
The Saint. Those obscure ones, they're good.
Oh, good.
Nice keep.
Nice.
Hey, hey! Oh!
These guys are gonna get wrecked.
See, this is
how you fucking do it.
Okay. That's how my roll should have gone.
Slate's just gonna come down.
He's checking it twice.
Because this is an extraordinary success, you override the lockouts.
Yes, I am.
Yeah. You override the lockout and have free reign to do whatever you like in the program.
He can see the code.
In this situation, I'm going to be... Because, obviously, I'm trying to find things that are in the simulation already to manipulate to this so I can do it quickly. I'm going to...
Please, put the giant snowman on them. Please.
It doesn't have to be a snowman.
No, it doesn't have to be a snowman.
I was going to have... I'm going to have... Santa's... I'm going to have a giant sleigh rise out of the ground beneath their feet. They tumble into the giant bag inside of it. And it's going to ride off into a nearby wall, into the nearby edge of the holodeck.
Yep.
Love it.
And just kind of crash into a pile, into a pile of simulated splintered wood and a very upset wiggling bag.
Perfect.
At this point, Jones is just jaw floor.
Yep. And that ends the combat rounds. There's nobody left.
Well, someone must have been naughty.
That was a good choice to go first.
Yeah.
Turns out if you just hack the game, you can spawn. You can just play Gmod.
Yep.
Okay. After making sure that they're secure in there, I turn the safety interlocks back on.
What's wrong with these Romulans?
Well, if this was Gmod, one of the Romulans would just have legs spazzing out in the corner.
Yeah, just wiggling.
These Romulans have all clearly got claustrophobia.
Okay.
Yeah.
So,
Powell, you know that now that you've got full access, there were only 6 Romulan life signs in the holodeck.
Okay.
That means that they're all gone now.
They were
we didn't kill them.
No.
But they're all taken disabled.
Yes.
Yeah, so now we need to find out what's happened with the others. Also, have you guys reported back in about this?
Yes.
We've met their boss yet. So, but wait, there's Mer.
God's sake.
I'm just gonna...
Frankly, Nav, sometimes your puns incense me.
No!
Yes!
This is just gold.
Oh, these are selling me.
These happened, they can't unhappen.
Yeah. A wise man wouldn't join in.
It's all right, guys. I've checked the Romulus pulses. They're all in a stable condition.
Don't be an ass.
Come on, you gotta give me credit for at least having balls or balls.
Okay. So
okay, enough with the puns.
Okay,
yes.
Okay. Yeah, I will
crash the grown.
Wait, hang on. So, Powell, have we taken them all out?
All the ones that are in the holodeck. It appears. Right. We actually probably should check the rest of the ship to make sure there's no one else around.
Can we drop the shield around the holodeck?
Assuming I have access to that, right?
Yes.
Yeah, I drop it.
But on this holodeck.
There are two, right?
Yeah.
Hmm. Yes. Because of how heavily you hacked the system, you can see that holodeck 2 is running a simulation called Warehouse.
We'll have to investigate that afterwards. But let's get the people out of this simulation first. Like, I'm assuming that once we drop the shield, we can see, like, the people back on the ship can see all the life signs.
Yep.
Captain, we've encountered some Romulans here. We've taken them out, but they appear to have been holding the people of the colony hostage and forcing them to do things. I don't know what. We'll have to go in this building and find out.
Excellent work, Jenkin.
Thank you, Captain. I did do well, didn't I?
Yes, indeed.
As he peeks up from behind the door.
Yep. Yes, well, I mean, he's the one that reported it, and he's the one in charge. Therefore,
yes. My mission.
He is taking the credit.
Yep.
This sounds like a diplomatic.
While he's reporting in,
we need to deal with too.
A very rotund Tellarite comes up to you.
Okay.
I just sort of raise one eyebrow.
Who's you?
Nicfrus.
Oh yeah, who's he coming towards?
The group in the holodeck.
Okay.
Right. What's he wearing?
It's a little bit
nice blue outfit. Nice shirt. Nice black trousers.
So not a like
red. White.
Yeah. No. Okay.
It only goes so far.
Yeah. He's got an overall over the top.
Okay. Sorry. Sir, can we assist you? Are you okay?
Federation. Excellent. Sint. Nicfrost Sint. You are?
Commander Jenkins.
Good.
Of the, what's the ship called?
Franklin.
USS Franklin.
Franklin. The mandated pronunciation is Franklin.
Yeah.
Yes.
Ferengi.
No.
He's not the same thing.
No.
Yeah.
Frankincense?
He's like, good job, Federation.
Please, no more.
No.
Okay, so.
Pun foul, using the same pun twice.
Yes, I know. Yeah. I'm sorry.
Yep. Good job, Federation. You take them into custody? Good.
What happened here?
Bye.
Well, could you explain, please? I'm very curious what happened here.
Yes.
Mercenaries. Yes. Force us to change production to weapons. You've done with. Excellent. Bye.
Okay.
Is this were there more? Tellarite,
Tellarites are very blunt. Can't really be bothered with long conversations. They just tell you to go away.
Can we please enter this building and secure the civilians?
The civilians are fine.
Okay. And can we ask if there are more?
We'd like to check that.
More Romulans? Are there more Romulans? Should we
not on board?
More Romulans?
Not on board. Mercenaries. They left small guards. Said they'd be back next week.
What kind of... were they all from against the mercenaries?
Did you find Templar? Is he okay?
He's very disjointed. He thinks you were kidnapped by a Yeti.
Ah, they left him there as a distraction. He'll be fine.
Is he with them, or did they do something to him?
They threatened him. Threatened his family.
Ah.
Hmm.
Told him to distract anybody who heard that distress call.
It also explains why the why he was so keen to get back.
Yes.
There's a quick pan round to Jenkins, and he's like fingering his sort of uniform where a medal might be put, and just sort of gazing off into the distance. He's not listening to any of this.
He's like, you've captured them. Yep. You don't need to be here anymore. We're fine. Go away.
We also need to figure out what... We would like to make sure that everything is okay on the rest of the ship first.
The ship's fine.
One of them mentioned a boss.
Yes, he left. Just, we'll be fine.
I'd like to
left
point out
where?
The coming back in a week comment.
Yes.
We've dealt with the guards now. We know they're coming back. We'll be fine. We'll change the simulation. They won't know.
But this ship doesn't have any weaponry.
Captain, one of these civilians is talking. I think he might want to talk to you.
Yes. Send Captain. Bring him over. Rest of you, go away.
Bye.
Let's check out. Let's make sure all the civilians get back home really quick, and then check out the other simulation. Maybe I'm confused.
Yes. Let's let's do that.
At this point, Jones is so confused, he's just going to go along with anyone else.
At this point, Sint just... Oh. We don't need to go back down to the planet. Winter, we come here.
Oh! That would explain the yearly expeditions.
Yes. We come here, we make toys in the workshop, store them in the warehouse, ship them away at the end of the season.
To whom?
Children.
Which children?
All across the Federation.
Oh, okay.
Wait. So you were
the
ones?
On the planet is this, where on the planet is this settlement located?
The Northern Hemisphere.
Oh, is it? Is it really?
Very northern, I'm guessing.
Yeah.
Is there a pole in the middle of the settlement?
No.
Damn it.
That'd be silly.
That'd be ridiculous.
At this point, Jenkins, you... the direction you've been walking in, your tricorder starts to pick up a weird subspace anomaly.
Oh, okay. Lieutenant Commander Powell, please come and inspect this anomaly.
Sorry, not Jenkins, Lloyd.
Oh,
word,
right.
Names.
Sorry, yeah.
Meanwhile, back on the planet.
Back on the planet, yeah, you're picking up a subspace anomaly. It looks like it might be the cause of the sensor interference.
Okay, so also when you cut back down, because we're in sort of a blizzard and just pulls himself out of a snowdrift. Right, which way are we going? Where are we? Everybody here? And they're waving their hands. So it's like, there's something over there, let's go that way. There seems to be some interference. So we're going to head towards the source of the interference.
Yep. And then we'll cut back to the ship.
Okay. Little cutaway. Just like putting... Maybe, actually, Jenkins is... Also, Lloyd Vernon has fashioned some makeshift
snowshoes. Don't you start as well. I can't fucking handle red and
you. All right, sorry, it's just me. He's made some snowshoes and out of some trees and tree bark and is just trying to push through.
So, is it okay? I'm assuming we've inspected the rest of the ship to try and see if there's any other Romulans. Any, if they put any traps or anything like that?
Yeah, your replacement operations officer tells you that there's no other Romulans on board, no other hidden areas on board the ship.
Okay.
The sensors seem to work very well for her.
While they're doing
I'm wondering some select words about that.
I'm just going to be looking to see what weapons they've been producing.
Yes.
Yeah, disruptor rifles mostly.
What Klingon, Romulan?
Romulan.
And are they in similar... Is there anything similar to those that we found in the abandoned space station a few episodes ago?
No, what you found there was Federation weapons being shipped.
Yeah.
These are right, Romulan these weapons being
made. There's no, they're not like being loaded into a similar crate or anything like that. No.
Well, you haven't gone to the warehouse section yet.
Yeah.
Right, we should probably do
which
that.
Which we should inspect just to make sure there's nothing wrong.
Yep.
You do that, I'm going to stay here and secure the civilians.
Just make sure everyone's okay and all that? And also stay out of the...
Yeah, yes. That's what I'm doing.
Okay, so...
Commander, wouldn't I be better suited for that task? Wouldn't your particular talent be more well-served with the rest of the team?
But, or how about both Reynolds and Jenkins stay with the Tellarite and civilians, and Lodwin and Alex go and have a look at the White House? And
seems
maybe
Petra
as well.
Yep. While you're discussing this with Sint, a small human child, about 10 years old, appears and asks if you'd like a tour.
Ah, shoot it!
Yep. Assuming everything's safe, yes, we'll want to be pursued very carefully because we have no idea what the Romulans have been up to. I'm assuming you guys have some idea, but we don't.
Okay, I'll pat the child on the head and say, sure, let's go.
Yep. So the child starts to give you a tour of the factory. They've kind of done something very clever with the holodeck, and manipulated it to produce lots of really clever manufacturing machines. Although the outside is wooden and rustic, the interior is all very clever and very high tech.
And do I ask the child, does the child work here?
The child says she doesn't work, but
the supervisor.
She's
the foreman.
Because all the parents are all up here, and they live up here because it's, although it's snowing outside, it's warm because it's a holodeck. So it's nicer up here. So they come and live up here, and they're allowed in the factory to see their parents and play games and.
Not violating any labor laws then.
Children playing nearby expensive manufacturing equipment can't ever possibly go wrong. That's fine. There's nothing wrong with
well,
that.
Normally the safety's wrong.
Normally the safety's wrong. I turned them back on. Everything is fine. Nothing is dangerous.
Now, why don't we just live in holodecks?
That's a very good question.
Over in the crates, in the warehouse section, the crates are mostly toys marked with the worlds they're being shipped off to.
But this is actually works. Like they don't dematerialize when they leave the holodeck. They're actually shipping out.
Well, for real objects that are being interacted with, the holodeck uses replicator technology to make the ship.
Okay.
Whereas here, I'm guessing some of the manufacturing facilities and equipment are, you know, like holodeck hard light holograms.
Yeah.
But you can use those to actually make real things.
The real materials.
Using real materials.
So, yeah, basically, through the rest of the year, they mine up the raw materials that they need, convert it to basically whatever matter the replicator needs, and then spend the winter producing their toys up on the ship, because it's easier to still use the holodecks than to try and build all the manufacturing stuff they need down on the planet. That's going to take them a few more years.
Also, it's warm.
Yes. So it's nicer. They can have it snowy and wintry, but it can still be a nice warm temperature. So they quite like that.
Great plan.
At one point, Bloodwyn spots a My Little Kalis figure. He's like,
yep.
Oh, cool.
Yeah. And you recognize these toys. They're on sale in various places around
more
the Federation.
More than no action figure.
Sale in the Federation.
Available for acquisition.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And, yeah, they're...
That was worse than now.
The warehouse, there's some crates of weapons. I mean, it was only a day ago that they got attacked, so they haven't really produced very much yet.
We should probably confiscate these weapons just in case.
There's a few similar markings on these weapons, but they don't appear to be exactly the same as the people who were smuggling Federation weapons.
Yes, Captain, this Tellarite wants to speak to you.
Okay. Let's put them on the comms.
I'll hand in my badge.
You can probably set up a comm on the ship.
Yeah, that's also true.
Whatever.
The ship that acts as a communication relay?
Yes.
Put him into communication with the captain somehow. I do the thing.
Yeah, so you can talk to Sint, ask him whatever you like.
Yes, Sint, I understand you wish to talk to me. We are here responding to a distress call, and we need to ensure that everyone is okay.
Yes, we're all fine. Your crew saved us all. Very brave. Captured the mercenaries.
Do you know why those mercenaries knew about the approach you guys had taken? Your manufacturing setup?
We had a few new colonists this year. Seems they were not as genuinely committed to the cause as we hoped. They relayed our secrets to the mercenaries, and the mercenaries sought to take advantage.
And
where are these particular colonists now?
Yep. Where are those colonists?
They left with the other mercenaries.
Which are expected back within a week.
Yes.
Oh.
We will need to. I apologize, but as it is important that we, for our processes, that we, our crew observes the civilian population for themselves.
Yes,
Captain. Do you plan to wait around here for a week, or do we have a more urgent mission to move on to?
Do we have a more urgent mission to move on to?
Well, I'm assuming you'd relay this back to High Command.
Yes.
Take your orders.
That's true, and then they can handle that, because this is certainly an attack upon Federation civilians.
They'll let us know if they want us to stick around and take care of it or not. Mm.
Yeah, exactly.
You're ordered to stick around and to deal with the situation when they return.
Mm. Okay. So we're going to have to lay a trap for these guys to make sure that they do as little damage as possible to this to your wonderful colony.
Yes, indeed.
Very well. But your crew has been given a tour. They've seen all the civilians. Everybody's fine. Please, can you just let us work in peace?
Yes. I can, at least. as we bag up the Romulans, I guess.
We can transport the Romulans off, right?
Yes. Put them in your brig. Perfect place for them. Just
yeah.
Shoot.
Throw them in.
Yes. This is a man who wants to make toys.
Yes. Wants out.
Yeah. So, do we leave them to it and prepare?
Do we have enough manpower for the toy manufacturing?
Yes.
Might want to. So, at this point, Vernon probably hasn't checked in a little bit.
Well, I was going to say Vernon has reached the subspace distortion that he found, and this is where the transporter pad is for receiving. And they've set up a building and a facility around it. It appears that there's several crates of toys already beamed down here. Possibly a few from last year. There's like a conveyor belt heading into the middle of nowhere, as far as you can tell. Except it's sort of framed by a small ring of equipment around the very exact point where the anomaly would be.
First I'm going to ask Templar, so what's this then? Do you know about this? Where are we?
Templar's like, you weren't supposed to come here. This is shipping and distribution.
Oh, shipping what? Because unless people want to fill Vernon in.
I'm assuming we sent you the message telling you what's happening, and then you didn't notice it.
Depends if I've read it or
so
not.
So Vernon hasn't noticed.
Yeah, he hasn't
noticed. Yeah, so Templar's like, shipping and distribution.
Well,
are these toys or are these weapons?
Vernon's going to...
recently renamed from Amazon?
Vernon's going to have a look through the boxes, try and see what's going on here.
Yeah, so there's some of last year's hottest action figures.
Model Defiant,
things like that.
The repainted one with the metallic paint.
Yes. some different games.
Detecting...
There's a nice rocking horse in one corner.
My little Romulan.
I'm detecting a subspace anomaly over there behind that conveyor belt. I have to check this out. You understand? So
at this point, Templar just puts his hand over the top of your tricorder and is just like, "Please, can we have some secrets? I'll tell you anything you want to know. Just don't ask about this."
What?
Red flag, meatball.
Yeah. I'm going to try to come up to the ship.
Yep.
Do the comms work?
They're a little bit crackly, but you can get through.
Come on, Captain. I may require some assistance. I'm at the end of there's some sort of shipping distribution.
I'm sorry, you're breaking up. I think we may need to send some people down to assist you.
Oh wait, well, we do have Goblin Lynn there already.
Yeah,
but I was like, yeah, need help, send team.
Okay. Well, I mean, the away team is already...
Don't need help, need no team.
Okay, so let's try and beam down as close as possible. I will, and... Who else?
We beam from over there?
Yeah, we could do that.
We don't have any warm clothing.
I do!
I do!
Oh! I brought spares!
Let's use our... No! Let's use our awesome transporters to beam the clothing onto us!
Oh yes,
I can cosplay.
Use my sight to
sight. Our character Vernon should suggest that.
Okay, yeah, no, you're not. I'm trying to. So
he's trying to, but
yeah,
can we
up. We'll try and suggest that. Okay. Vernon's going to try and boost the signal to his comm badge to get through, because Goblin. I'm going to say that Goblin are restraining Templar at the moment.
Yeah,
and so Vernon is going to try and. He's not approaching the conveyor just yet. He's going to wait for the others. But he's going to try and boost the signal to his comm badge to get a clear signal through, so that we can decide what to do. So he can talk to.
While Vernon's tinkering with that, Templar's like his demeanor's changed a bit now. He's not trying to be as obsequious and helpful and friendly as he was, and he's like, did nobody. Ever really wonder why we wanted to come to this place?
Not really.
I did.
I wondered.
Well, okay. So
where are we?
You guys aren't. Are you not,
yes.
You're not there yet. So yeah, we wanted to come to this place. Nobody thought about it. We thought you seemed so insistent on it, but nobody really quite got why. But it's fine.
And he points where the anomaly is, and he says, "That's why."
Huh. And so, yeah, I'll just
set up. It gives us the fastest distribution network in this quadrant. We can get toys out to everybody, every store, as quickly as possible.
Impossibly fast shipping.
He's like, just
ridiculously fast moving.
Can you please not bring the Federation here and spend months analysing? Can you just let us use it? We just want to send out toys. We just want people to be happy. If you involve the Federation, if you bring all your scientists here to figure out how it works, we will never be able to send another toy.
It's a deal.
Hey, I'm the one making the deals.
I'll tell you where all the colonists are. I'll tell you what's going on. Just please, don't bring them down here.
Lloyd, have you informed him that we rescued everyone yet?
I can't hear you.
I know.
I actually have no idea what's been going on. That's the thing. I've been separated and out of comms, and this message on the pad. I haven't read it.
I know.
So
this is what I'm saying into the static, the uncaring static.
Like,
and as he finishes his plea, you finish fiddling with your comm badge, and the signal gets through clearly.
So, quick thing out of character. This is a suggestion. Is this an Iconian gateway? This could be an Iconian gateway.
Oh, yeah, that's basically where I'm going with it. They've added some stuff to control it, but
right. Okay. That was just. I wasn't sure if that's where you were going with that. Yeah. Okay. Right.
I never even thought of that. That's brilliant.
Back in character then. So
in character, you just got like 50 bajillion dings on your tricorder.
Just like, oh, okay. Answer those. No, okay. No, mute notifications. So Vernon's thinking about it, and this guy, you know, he's been very nice to him. He's talked to him. He's the only person who's listened to him in a long time about what's been going on, and he's had a look through the boxes and they're all toys. He doesn't know about the weapons, so comes back up.
Do you believe in Santa Claus?
Captain, Captain, can you hear me now? Am I coming through?
Is he coming through?
Yes.
Yes, clear. You're reading.
Didn't even make me roll for it. No, I'm coming through. There seems to be some sort of. Just everything's fine. We're all okay down here. We went looking for the Yeti. We never found it.
Yes, we have information that the Yeti was merely a distraction.
Oh, that makes perfect sense then. That makes perfect sense. Haven't been able to find out, looking at Templars, haven't been able to find the source of the subspace disturbance, though, so I think we'll head back. We'll head back. We'll head back and rendezvous. I'll take Templar back to the village, or back to the settlement, and I'll rendezvous with the rest of the crew on the ship.
Okay.
Commander Lloyd, out. Beep. So, turn to Templar. There. I'll keep your secret for you. But only because I like you.
Only because you listen to me.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you, Vernon. You're a good man. And he goes over to one of the boxes, digs in, and brings out a child's science kit, and he hands it to Vernon gleefully.
Oh, is this the model 15 from the set of? Oh, this is a practically retro. Oh, this is brilliant.
This is what you always wanted. What you dreamed of as a kid, right?
Yeah.
This is what you got. This is what you wanted to get instead of socks.
Yeah. Well, thank you, and he hands out a few toy guns to Gob and Lynn.
Yeah.
And they seem reasonably happy. And so we're going to start heading back. But Vernon did get a few scans off before Templar stopped him. So he is, as they're walking back, he's looking down and analysing the data surreptitiously.
Yep, I'll allow that.
Yay. It probably won't come up, but he just got a couple things off. All right, so we're going to head back to the way we came, and when we get back there, transport back up to the ship.
Yep. Templar asks if you can beam him up to the colony ship.
I'm sure that could be arranged. We can arrange that. In fact, I tell you what, if we want to do that, then we might as well go now. Captain, wait, did I transport a room? Hello?
Okay.
Beam up to the thing.
Yeah.
One to beam up. Or two to beam up, and then we'll send him on from the ship.
Are we going to activate?
You're not beaming up Gob and Lynn. It's just you and
Templar. Right, no, four to beam up. I can count. Four to beam. Actually, no. You know what? No, this is in Vernon's character. Two to beam up.
Yeah.
He forgot about Gob and Lynn.
Yeah.
Two for Santa's workshop, please.
Yes.
Or Saint Nick's workshop.
So we beam away, and Gob and Lynn are just standing there, what the heck? They're frantically tapping their comms.
And then they get beamed up a little bit after.
Which don't work because I didn't fix theirs.
Yeah.
So they have to trudge back through the snow to get a clear signal.
Yeah. When they finally get beamed up really wet and cold, they're really miserable.
Someone's not getting a hazard team.
They may not work with me again, it's true.
And next episode, Victor's hazard team has a cold.
And that's where we'll do that. Finish that there. Presume your presence in the system is noticed. You stay at the planet for a week, but no more ships are detected in the system. So
there must have been some sort of signal that they were expecting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Well, they came in and saw that there was a Federation ship there and decided to leave.
Yep.
So the cheesy Christmas special.
It took you a long time to figure out that it was the cheesy Christmas special.
It did.
You told me it was that.
I know, but you weren't here.
I was keeping quiet about it.
I figured it out with the Saint Nick, but I wasn't going to say anything in case.
Yeah,
I
was wrong. Yeah. No, no, like, I didn't want to give it away.
You don't say anything, even if you do figure it out. You play along, because that's the most fun way.
I knew when I got to Nick Frost since that that would give it away. But that was the point where I needed it to be given away.
I posted a link in the Twitch chat to the Abominable Snowman from the Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer Rankin-Bass special. Because I was like, I wonder.
Well, I was just thinking, right at the end of the episode, as the ship is preparing to leave orbit, the crew come back to their quarters and all find a little box at the end of their bed.
A little present
that they wanted from their youth, except for Jenkins, who gets a lump of coal, perhaps.
Jenkins gets his swimming certificates back, neatly framed again.
A nice new frame for the certificates,
And Jones has just got a box of the weapons.
my little Kalis.
A bat left.
Yeah.
That's wonderful.
And so, yes, so and because you've helped them, and this is something that's not come up before in Trek, but that comes up periodically in Firefly, is you now have these guys to call on as allies.
Yeah.
Well, with their present delivering technology, they could be anywhere.
Yep. So, should the need ever arise in the future, you can contact Hrenna IV and Thanksgiving, and they might be able to help you.
So, actually, a really interesting way this works is that you get, if you don't spend it to upgrade your character, you get this episode as a plot point to use. Which means you can, like, say, so remember that time when we, you know, found that planet that could send us crazy stuff from out of nowhere? Yeah. That could be relevant right now.
Interesting. Nice.
And so
you know the nice people with a shipping network and a whole hollow suite full of replicators?
Yeah. I mean, you know, we're obviously core gamers because we appreciate free 2-day shipping.
I mean, I don't know if that counts as 2-day shipping, but I'm on board with it anyway.
Well, at least maybe quicker.
Yeah, exactly, right?
A thought I have is that due to a clerical error on their part, they ended up sending every single Alex Powell a present. Yes. And a lot of them are very confused.
The same person saying thank you for your help. A little card saying thank you for your help. And the rest of them are all confused.
So it just falls to you to name the episode.
Well, until we got to all the Christmas special, it was going to be something like the bare minimum or the bare necessities. Because that's how everyone was rolling. But I feel like we need like a more Christmassy themed name.
Make it snow?
Oh, that's a good one.
Make it tense.
Make it snow.
Make it snow is very good. Santa's helpers or subordinate clauses?
Or should that be insubordinate clauses?
Wait, I've got one.
Yeah?
Clear and present danger.
Oh, that's terrible.
Present danger.
That's terrible.
I think that wins.
Yes.
That's always wins this.
I'm on a 4-episode streak.
Yes, you are.
It's kind of like doing the Farscape rewatch podcast and playing with the titles all the time gives him an advantage.
Yes.
Yeah. It's true. Well, it's writing the blurbs for Twitter mostly. The website.
That's so good.
So yes, thank you for joining me on this silly adventure.
Thank you, Keith. Sorry, I was late.
Yeah, thanks, Keith.
It's fine. I know we've kind of gone back-to-back holiday specials now, Halloween into Christmas, but...
I mean, it's that time of the year.
It's
the way the TV season goes, yeah.
It was too good an opportunity not to use one, and I had the idea for how a Santa's workshop would work in Trek technology.
That's really cool.
So was it intentionally? Was it supposed to be an Iconian gateway?
Yes.
Okay, that's great then. Because
I was like saying, surrounded by equipment. I was hesitant because as I was doing it, I realized you might not all get Iconian gateway, and you might all go to Stargate.
I was thinking
about Iconian gateway. Just Red just mentioned something in the chat about the.
Oh, don't worry. I know what that's about. Don't worry about that.
Was it?
No. I'm thinking you could use the Iconian gateway.
Was there an Iconian Gateway in any of the reboot films?
No,
no. I don't remember it.
No, Iconian Gateways were in... There was an episode of TNG.
And one episode of DS9.
DS9, yeah.
Oh,
I believe they get mentioned in the online as well, but I've
played it. Yeah, basically
they've recently had an Iconian event, I think, online.
Basically, right, they're a big window that can transport you to anywhere in the galaxy and in the universe.
Right.
Yep.
And they're like ancient artifacts that are really powerful. So.
Yeah. Exochix, yes. Those of you who can see the video, Edison has just appeared.
It's Edison? Is that
He's
Edison?
Been outside, and he is soaked through because it's raining, but because he's a fluffy cat, it all sits on top of his fur.
Is this his first appearance on stream then?
Yeah, he is now shaking it off like a dog, and he's just
right next to you,
wet.
As is the custom of his people.
Lovely.
That's his tradition. Yep. All
right. But yes, this is the majestic Edison. It's his first appearance on stream.
Hey.
The guest director for this episode is Nick Frost.
Yes.
Yeah. So that's what I was going to mention. So when you said like the Nick Frost, whatever his name was, my thought wasn't initially like, oh, Christmas. It was like, what, like Hot Fuzz.
It's also because
Cornetto 21.
Yes. It's Nick Frost is kind of like perfectly named for that.
Yes.
Which I loved it when he was in the Doctor Who Christmas special.
I was
with Santa.
That myself. Doctor Who
played Santa in the Doctor Who special.
He did, didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
And so when I was looking for a Tellarite name, Nick Frost kind of fitted reasonably well, and I was like, he needs a surname. And so he was Nick Frost since.
How many episodes we've done now?
Four.
This is fourth episode.
What was the third episode?
Naked Howl. That was the last one. It was the Naked Howl is what it was called.
Yeah.
And the guest director for that is Leslie Nielsen.
It was ridiculous. Alright, before we finish... Oh god, that was loud.
Edison says hi.
Hello, Edison.
But before we finish off properly, there is a small matter of a post-credits scene.
Yes.
Oh.
I'm just going to say up front, don't worry about what happens in this scene. Everything will be fine.
Yes!
This is not canon.
But Vernon is in the engineering, deep in his pile of junk, assembling some things, looking at the readings he took from the Iconian Gateway. He was working on a project already, and this data is really helping him. And so he set up like a little array of devices, and there's a focusing beam, and he fiddling with it and turns it on, and this big portal appears, a small portal appears in engineering, and he gets sucked through along with some of that equipment, and then it's gone. To be continued.
To be continued tomorrow, in fact.
Indeed. In fact, to be continued on another show.
Yes. We may be engaging in a small crossover a la the DC universe.
Yeah, very much like that.
So yes, tomorrow is still in the calendar as Can't Take the Sky From Me. But because we're going to be down a major character, we are having some fun. And so
Red
will be GMing for us. We have ported all our Firefly characters over to
one Star Trek character.
It was surprisingly easy to convert everyone's characters to Edge of the Empire.
Because the two systems are very similar.
I did all of that.
And so we will be in the Star Wars universe using the Star Wars Edge of the Empire system, which I've not streamed with before, but have played one game with Nav's usual D&D group, and it's great fun. And so we will be having an adventure with Firefly characters and one Star Trek character in the Star Wars universe.
Yeah.
They're Star Wars-ized versions of the...
So they aren't the same crew ported over like Vernon is. They are Star Wars versions of the crew.
I was just going to imagine Vernon suddenly arriving as a Wookiee.
And so I have yet to discover what character I will be playing.
In another universe.
So interesting, just a quick thing about Vernon's character. We gave him the talent, which is called Utility Belt, which is the most fun talent in the game. You can randomly pull out items from your utility belt that are just happen to perfectly fit the situation to help you out in exactly that moment.
Perfect.
So it's a cartoon belt.
It's Batman's utility belt. It's
basically it's Batman's belt.
Yeah.
They figured out how to build portals to Hammer Space.
Yeah, pretty much. I'm Batman.
It's gonna be real good.
That's gonna be a lot of fun. I'm glad I was able to make that. Because actually, quick thing, we might be moving culture. We'll probably be moving Culture Clash earlier in the day.
Because HP.
He's crazy that he wants to actually do it, but fine. Okay, we'll accommodate that.
I just happened to notice you can't play Minecraft. Is that supposed to be Mint's Raft?
Nobody pointed that out to me during the entire stream. I was a bit tired when I wrote that.
Well, the thing is, Mint's Raft is actually canon because there is that one login screen.
There's a very small chance that, the on the login to Minecraft, it actually says Mint's Raft instead.
So, we haven't actually ported over Eliza's character yet, so it's basically up to you whether you want to play Eliza or Isaac or Zaps, and I will just play whoever you end up not picking.
Well, I've just got to go AFK for a bit. So
yeah, I think I'm going to play Zaps. So, yes, we have hit our 10 o'clock limit, so I think that's where we'll wrap up. Edison also needs to be towed dry, so
yes.
Yes, so thank you everybody for watching. Sorry about the delay and the technical issues, but we had a fun adventure anyway. I didn't have to cut too much out to make up for the starting delay, so yeah. Thank you all, and we'll see you tomorrow for a very special Firefly episode.
I believe it's tentatively titled Can't War the Stars from Me, or something like that.
Maybe my fault. Yes, it's definitely titled Can't War the Stars from Me, and it's definitely my fault.
So, yes, thank you all for watching, and bye!
We'll see you tomorrow!
Bye!
Bye.
Farewell!
Bye!
Bye!